So look, it says chat is on, but I have put chat off, all right? Now, N.E.A.L, I'm in horizontal mode, which means I'm trying to get, first, I want to zoom in on this bird because there are a few of them left and they were about to become extinct. Extinct, instinct, extinct. Like the dinosaurs. And I filmed them in 2020 in this same spot, showing this exact same place. There were no people because it was the pandemic and there were these lockdowns. On this side, there was this Disney cruise ship that just so huge, it blocked the mountains there that are being blocked by the clouds and haze over there. It was a totally gray day, but windy, exactly, like back in 2020. There's been this wind, it won't leave. It gets into the stream. People start complaining about the sound. N.E.A.L, they take it out on me. I wasn't doing anything. I was being sober on that day. It's this day. It's coming up too. The day of the viral video. It's on somebody's birthday. You should have remembered. 1600 videos for you, N.E.A.L. It wasn't for anybody else. It was just for you. That's a lot of hours. My daughter, who's going to school over there at the college, her professors, who really, N.E.A.L, we need the money, the understanding to continue to do our scientific experiments. They're still here, those birds. You didn't do anything about it. Now look what's happening over here, N.E.A.L. From YouTube Corporate. I can't see when I zoom in anything. Are you seeing what I'm seeing in my screen? You're not, you're seeing something else. It's out of focus. Yeah, because you allowed me, boss, to be surrounded by police. Back then, because I was what? What was I gonna do? What, you said you were saving me. You thought I was gonna jump off this bluff. No, look, coastal bluff area, unsafe and subject to erosion. Dogs and all persons prohibited. So I didn't do it. I'm a good citizen. I've been a good citizen here since 1969, when there was an oil spill. And if you can look out there, they're still there. Those are fracking devices out there. I don't know if you see it. It's all in a haze out there. There are some islands. We couldn't see them back in 2020 either. But anyways, those fracking devices are shut down, supposedly. They're just sitting out there because the Shell Corporation, get this, N.E.A.L, the Shell Corporation can't afford to take them with them. Just take it back to New York. What is all that oil thing? Well, they're just getting ready to blow. They're called fracking devices. I kept saying fracking devices, and everyone on YouTube, because of your system, thought that I was saying, you know, instead of saying the F word that we can't say anymore. it's gonna change, right? Well, back in those times, they thought I was an active shooter. I looked like an active shooter. I dressed like it. I've been walking around the streets. I had been getting in trouble with every Shell gas station because they weren't washing their bathrooms, and I was pointing out to them, right, Neil? Now we know how important it is. Whoa, you wash your hands, you clean those things. If you want us to wash our hands, and it's some sort of federal law, you can't be kicking around some homeless dude who has been here before any of those organizations that weren't letting me into their establishment to wash my hands, to use the bathroom. Do you know what it's like, Neil, to do an off-grid van life? Oh, isn't that beautiful? Back then I could photograph all that stuff. My iPhone 8 camera lens wasn't all smashed, and my hand wasn't either, Neil. You were my boss. I read your signs. It said federal law, wash your hands. You are told I'm an active shooter. You tell the world you were trying to save me from committing suicide. You don't allow me to use the word suicide on your platform just to talk about the incident. And so you even take away my ability to talk about a band by the name of Suicide with Alan Vega and Mercury Rev that we are going to be pushing up in the trendings now, right, Neil? Things have changed. You're not sending me trolls, I saw. You're sending me the right crowd. People who tell the truth. It is beautiful, isn't it? I'm so glad they didn't shoot me. I just didn't understand why the What was I doing that made them so nervous? These policemen who get a call from you. Well, Susan, thank you for firing Susan. I was upset at first because we had worked with her for so long. She was finally understanding us. But Neil, I've been seeing on the platform some amazing changes. So I am grateful, like I am grateful to the government. But I wasn't back then, right? And they came all around from all, see how that van is coming up, Neil? Well, there was like a SWAT thing, and then over there, and then I'm like, who are all these people? And they're suddenly saying, give us the phone. Give us the phone. Give us the phone. That's going to be our code word this year. Any of you trolls caught outside dissing Obama on an Obama phone, whomever you're connected to, you start showing your Nazi smug and your Confederate flags that you've been burning. They've been burning the flag. Hold on, Neil, was that you? They've been burning the Confederate flags all over the world as a protest for the Lord. Maybe I don't have to redo today. Today, in the year 2020, things were so different, children. Well, first of all, this wasn't falling into the sea like that. But they put a lot of signs, and then there was a lot of deaths. I want to say a rest in peace right now for everybody who accidentally fell off this bluff, or it's falling into the sea, or they wanted to fall into the sea. There's a lot of plastic out there. There's a lot of plastic. And when we collect the plastic that has choked a stork, we always find something marked in little tiny print, like the corn molasses that are going to be hidden in everything we eat. It says made in China. Made in China. Now, when the police start to look up the story about this band that I was in, back in the days when there was a cafe up the street there, and it was full of artists and autistic analysts and journalists of a truthful nature and other types. There was the bourgeoisie of the script writers, well, wannabe script writers for sitcoms, and we would make fun of them while we were trying to be like Percy, or I'm not even sure I'm pronouncing that name right. You know what I'm saying. I'm full of it. I have delusions of grandeur. I am the doctor, the Lord. BS. N.E.A.L., what does that BS stand for? Is it my bachelor's of science in the analytics of the anagrams? Or is it my BS in the cellistic fantasy Bach recognition and knowing the difference between how I play Bach, N.E.A.L., and how Yo-Yo Ma plays Bach? One of the times that you had me taken down and you struck my channel and you did it in front of everybody and they all thought I was some sort of criminal, after working for you for so long and telling the truth for so long and writing it down on paper so you, there's proof, not your bots and their 100-character boxes to write my way out of court while you allow these trolls to come and just say, I F you, all day and all night long. That's how you protected me. Now, the only reason why you're in real big trouble, and you know it, as the disgruntled YouTuber that you hadn't been following my series that was telling you exactly what I was doing, but it was telling you it was parody and satire. And you're messing with my speech right now. I heard it. Autistic people of the world, unite. We all are all autistic. We're anarchist autistic. Nobody believes we got it. The doctors don't know either. Just know it. If you are schizophrenic, we all know the doctors don't know anything. It's true. We're all different. They can't tell us how we will be, how we're thinking, what we should do. I'm sorry. After 20 years of doing it, I figured it out. And not only that, I can tell anybody anything now because it's whatever's online. And I got the proof with my own daughter, who's known me for 19 years, knows my feelings about me lying to her. And she's looking at her phone. It's not an Obama phone. And the phone's telling her that I'm crazy. But crazy doesn't mean I'm mentally ill, so it doesn't count. Mentally ill, you can't discriminate against a mentally ill person, like the trolls were discriminating against me, and they kept getting the game wrong. They were supposed to. It's an easy game. figure out what is the mental illness that I'm suffering of. Not, it doesn't exist. That's not helpful. I keep telling everyone, those are my catchphrase, is since I was a kid in 1969, watching all of that over there, do you wanna see? I'll show you the white beach. Now it's just white and speckled with little black spots that we, you know, we put signs like it's natural seepage. Natural seepage. All right, that's fine. Shell, corporation, Jeremy, the owner of most of the gas stations in my little burg that during the pandemic, you wouldn't let me even get gas afterwards. You lie to me and say there's not a picture of me in the back that you were telling everyone. Don't let that long hair. You told them long hair because I was the only long hair, at least out in the pandemic, that was walking around. Santa Barbara, home of the newlyweds and nearly deads. They just didn't recognize me. I'm this teacher, right? For at least 30 years, I proved that, all right, my rock and roll background, I'm letting it go, right? I learned Johnny Thunders died in New Orleans, where my ex is right there going, looking around, trying to find out what happened in the story of Johnny Thunders. Was it really fans who stole his methadone and gave him acid instead? I don't know. Can you overdose on acid? You see how that story's all wrong, but that's the story that they're gonna give everybody. So we're gonna find out the truth now, N.E.A.L., right? We're gonna clean up those other channels. Please. Look at that. Look at the reef. All right, let's go back to our children's special. All right, children, you see all the little boats out there? Yeah. Cool, huh? At Christmas time, we put lights there. This is all true, people. I'm not lying. Let's turn our fantasy into reality. Let's manifest what's going to happen. But it doesn't have to be evil like how they did it in the last game we were playing. Yeah, the game. Look over there, that's the kids that made some sort of teepee out of wood. Remember doing that, children. It's our inner child. So N.E.A.L., you will be following my channel closely, so that's nice. But the Adult Protection Services calls me first thing in the morning just because I'm leaning over. Suddenly they're calling me. I see they're calling me. I do that thing like I do with everyone. I'm going to just let it cycle and then it'll, you know, they'll leave me alone. But somehow the Adult Protection Services, they have something, N.E.A.L. Do you have this thing where I can't hang up on them? Yeah. And they'll just keep ringing for the entire day to make sure I didn't jump over the fence because they've been following me. They're helping me. It is awesome. Look at the size of those waves. Oh. Now, when I was a kid, we would picnic right there. And it was really nice, spend the whole day. Now we can't do that. It's not the fault of anybody, except this tree is gonna fall into the ocean. We're falling into the sea. Now, do you remember when we were saying that back, let's say in 1976, and you all said it was a conspiracy theory? I don't want to move on. That's my whole point. I want to understand why you thought my whole video series about life in the streets in the year 2020 during the pandemic, when there were no people and the occasional person who would come around like this would hear me talking into my phone, and they would come over and say, "What are you doing?" Right? Because some YouTube influencers came into my burg from LA, Kill City, Point Doom, and they caused destruction with their YouTube channels and ruined my town. Well, prepared my town for a terroristic attack for next time. So I was upset that all the old establishments that I had been going into were treating me like they didn't know who I was and acting like I was some sort of criminal, when I was like, "You guys know me. What did I do wrong?" And then I turned on the YouTube. Yikes. And I saw what I did wrong. I turned it on. It didn't work. Like, what's going on here? I'm just trying to get that sign to show you that it says coastal bluff area unsafe and subject to erosions. Dogs and all persons prohibited. You see, they're gonna bust your dog here if he's out alone, falls off the bluff. They're covered. It's just about money. But I'm thinking, I'm getting it, N.E.A.L. If we put all that money into the government portion of this social media and we make you, YouTube, the government, they will have to decide then if we're going to be communist or not, if we'll be able to say that word or not. But we are in a time where you're not going to be able to make anyone disappear like Lenny Bruce and what happened now lately to somebody out in Russia. We can't be doing that because they came out with a movie just of late of the story of a reggae guy. We have to say it like that. A reggae dude who got some shoes from, let's say, DT, and there was a little nail inside of it to make it uncomfortable. It's something that Steve Martin, he did a bit about. It was one of his bits. It's called the cruel shoes. I'm going to right now steal someone's material, N.E.A.L., so you hear what it is. Stealing someone's material. It will not be me playing naked in my house privately, the Bach suite that I guess Yo-Yo Ma also played it on your platform. And I guess he told you I stole his material. At least that's what the robot sent me, N.E.A.L. Yeah, you see how funny this is. You guys thought I was crazy, and my friends thought I was just being funny. But the fact of the matter is, we're all still in the same place. That homeless man was still there back in 2020. So there's a truth to that. And there are homeless here, but we're taking care of them. So we don't need trolls to try to help us take care of our own homeless. Like your shell taking care of the oil spill, which this corporation let it go for so long, wouldn't let us clean up our own ocean as we're looking at it, as this corporation up in his 2000th sky high in the sky high rise in New York City, and you told us we couldn't do it because it's your land. Well, that's why the American Indians took it back from you. They're laughing because they're listening. They think it's funny. The Indians. Who are the Indians? Is he talking about the Indians with the dot over their heads, or the Native American Indians, what are they doing? They're taking back the Chumash exhibit. Oh, my childhood. You guys, you're taking with fences my childhood so that we, you know, we don't hurt ourselves. The people whom you are saying that it was because the mountain eroded, they were taking their own lives. They were connected to a governmental thing, UCSB. UCSB has a radio station. My friends and I had been controlling it since the 70s. Now, you can try to prove this. You never will be able to. That's our advantage, that all sorts of records were lost. But Cool Water, which is just a new digital thing, which you're all connected to, every radio station, the last DJ, that's what Tom Petty was singing about. What did you guys do to him? You killed him off. You want to say, there he goes. All right, his mental illness is showing. It really doesn't matter. It's a story that's becoming true. It's historical fiction. You can't prove it. I'm here. You can't tell me that that's not who's the celeb of the day. Oop, let's not get him. We're in a dead zone here. We can't photograph the celebs. That's why they come here. That's why they're really pissed when they have some YouTubers come around and mess up the situation. And that's what they did. Los Angeles, Kill City, Point Doom. You come into my burg, you need a permit here. I kept telling you that. Anyways, those are saved by, if you just take a boat right now straight, you will run into UCSB. And there were scientists there that saved these birds that I can't photograph for your channel. And you just said, go get a really good camera. All right, N.E.A.L. That's what I was trying to get Susan to understand. I wasn't putting down your fascistical, I sometimes go into a Marilyn Manson mode just to scare people off. Stop listening to my phone conversation. I'm just a dude. That's what I told the cops. Enjoying that first sip feeling that turns out, we found out, N.E.A.L., on the East Coast, there's another corporation that uses that catchphrase. What happened to them during the pandemic? Well, they are no more. So this tea leaf, we're just going to say coffee and tea leaf that we used to love going to, that there were people from that San Marcos High School that I was talking about, would meet up there, these theater kids, and we would scheme. Yeah. We had schemes. We had plans. Those of you playing the Seinfeld portion of the show, can you hear it? I think the adult protection services are coming to save my inner child. It's all right, guys. I'm not jumping. Not today. Thanks. All right, N.E.A.L. I want to thank you. No, I'm not being sarcastic. No, that's the problem. I told you there's going to be a problem, N.E.A.L. I don't know if I'm talking to you or the AI. You've gotten really good. And notice that I thumbs up to you right away, like you've told me at the university, to make sure you thumbs up your idol. My idol is you, N.E.A.L. And you are Jim Jones? Why did you send a troll talking about Jim Jones, it threw me into a loop. Did the character stop making any sense? Is that what you want to do? I still win. There's no doctor that's going to say, that's not a mental illness that he's going through. He was actually saying all that. He's very clear of mind. It's so obvious I'm not. And it's so obvious you were the ones pushing me to do this. I got addicted to your job. You gave us a job. You promised us things. And we're falling apart like this. It wasn't here in 2020, that new fence of more land. This isn't going to be here. Like probably in 10 minutes. Is that why they're calling me? Is that a warning? Hold on. Are they telling us something? Is it happening today? N.E.A.L. I'm nowhere near the security. The national security is down there. I'd have to walk all the way. I'll have to walk all the way down to the pier. I already did that. I already did that live stream. There's no way. I can't get those cranes to come back. I cannot get that boat to just show up. I'm all those people who walked into the shot. I can't hire another old lady to stick her hands down my pants on camera for no reason, right? Do you remember that live stream? That was elder abuse. She was way older than me. Then it was child abuse. It was... She was messing up my inner child. Why did she do that? What did I do to deserve that, N.E.A.L.? And you're saying there's no proof. That never happened. What did you do with the videos? Well, we have copied every one of them. Dude, after you've taken a whole year of like 3 videos a day, didn't you say, N.E.A.L.? No, that's what Susan said, right? Be consistent. Now, how do you like my consistency? Every day. Hour, 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 hour. We're at 1,159.50, I don't know. Stop interrupting me like a troll. Dude, it's a filibuster. The only way I can go wrong is if I stop talking, and I'm not gonna do that. Look, those are the swimmers. Can you see them out there? Of the City College. City College is over there. That's their bandstand. Over there, I guess they have football games and stuff. You've put the typewriter keyboard in front of my face, N.E.A.L. This is what they do. How am I going to, I don't even know how much time we've been doing. 13 minutes. No, 33. And 30, oh, I missed it. We just made it to 33 minutes and 33 seconds. Exactly, I was trying to see if that one worked with you guys. Is that the perfect amount of time? But I saw, I gotta explain this to you, N.E.A.L., as a human. Only a human will understand this. You have me using your university, which we've been calling vidIQ, and I notice that I go down in the rankings and people unsubscribe whenever I mention them. So I'm not gonna do that. We're gonna do like Jack Kerouac. We're gonna give him a funny name and everyone will know. Like in a Lenny Bruce skit. They'll know what the words are. We're the instigators. The thing is, I think the government has learned it's better that we just have the instigators. Like out in the open, we can watch them. We're worried about that guy because it said online, N.E.A.L., that I'm a terrorist, a domestic one. Now, they might have made a mistake about some sort of domestic abuse that might have happened inside the household, but that was toward me. That was, I didn't even want to talk about it back then. That's not fair, N.E.A.L., that got misinterpreted as though I am the adult in that situation, and that I do those kind of things, and that I want you, YouTube, to send me trolls who are into that kind of thing. Into what? Into the word that triggered your disgruntled YouTuber. Do you want to know what it is? I'm going to tell you. The words were, the government never lies. That's one of them. There's going to be another one. I just asked you to make sure when we push that button that you've given to us, to make sure that the chat is off. I was explaining to you and to Streamlabs, the people keep writing. It doesn't matter if just because I wrote chat is off and I push a button that supposedly turns off the chat, and then right now in my face, after saying chat is off, I'm going to put that in the title, chat is off. N.E.A.L., right now I see a troll that we ejected yesterday for a reason, because they did not follow one rule. N.E.A.L., what mafiosi terroristical organization is going to accept one troll who won't do one simple thing? None. You don't need the AI to look it up. You don't need the government to look it up. It was bad to allow them to be hiding and have you swatting us. You must drag them out of hiding. And you must always put this in the community garden right there in the chat. Always give out your personal information. You have to be covered. You never covered that, because personal information is different from your governmental information, which is things like social security numbers. Now, if we can freely give out, like in a communistic state, our social security numbers, none of this would have ever happened. And all you did for an entire year, 2020, was take down all those videos while letting these trolls make videos dissing my idea. They were laughing at it because it was so perfectly true. Now, you find out so much later, 5 years later, somehow you finally decided that my stuff was serious enough to actually look into it. Thank you. But look how far I had to go. 5 swattings. N.E.A.L., I can guarantee you, you have never had 5 swattings in different locations. Funnily enough, every location I had done a 5150 with my daughter. N.E.A.L., a 5150 is the Baker's Act in Florida. We're giving out education here now. It just means that in the government, it's going to save you. You're either going to hurt yourself or hurt someone else. That's awesome in concept. Not if the trolls say that you're not a mentally ill person in need of a social worker, maybe, or some different tactics than a whole bunch of policemen with their arms raised, and then it takes them to the 5th time in this city. Do you know how small it is? We started recognizing everybody. At one swatting, the cop came over, sat next to me, and said, "Hey, we like doing this with you, Kreiden. You guys are never violent." Right? And I said, violent, there's one. How would I be violent with the violin, right? I told him that joke. I said, you know, the AI is going to get violence and violins wrong just because it was in a Saturday Night Live show and they said, we don't watch television. You see, they're one up on us. They're one of those. They don't watch television. They don't eat meat. They don't use foul language, even when you need to use it. I'm not saying we take out the profanity or the N-word, N.E.A.L., but hey, if it needs to be, our character, Kramer, right? We're trying to do this like up-to-date Seinfeld, a remake. Our character, Kramer, goes back to that comedy club to redo the bit where, you know, 20 years before, he had been taken down by the original YouTuber when there was no YouTube, and the first person to figure out how to film something on their telephone. No, they had a camera. They had come in to just film this Kramer and for free, right? Then they're going to upload it to this viral online that didn't exist yet. They were just passing it around to their friends through MySpace or something, I think, back then. Or maybe not. No, that probably didn't even exist. AI, correction, from the 90s to the year 2000. Before BT. Before toilet paper. BTP. Perfect. We gotta stay relaxed. We gotta stay funny. Mitchell, I will read your comments because they're right on my face right now. You don't see what I'm seeing, but I'm trying to like film everyone. And right now there's all your writing. So there's a line here. It's all blurry to me. There's something there. And then there's your name, Mitchell. I know, Mitchell, you're not in our cult. You understand that I'm from the cult. Mitchell, why did you mention Jim Jones? Why didn't you say it was the AI that told you that Jim Jones was your idol? Those were the trigger words. Why are you coming in here, Mitchell? Now you're covering up the ocean and nobody's seeing it. And I'm not gonna say what you're saying right there because it had to do with, I just ask you guys, when I say the chat is off, I know the thing's broken and that N.E.A.L. will never fix it. And they're gonna pretend that it does work. But the people are still chatting. Why don't the people just go, oh, okay, he's trying to do that monologue. He's trying to do a monologue. It should only take 5 minutes. We are now almost, you know, an hour into the show. He has been talking all the time. We just haven't been listening. Occasionally we space out. That's normal. We're human. We've been brought up on 1 minute TikToks. I was supposed to get it all in there in that first minute. Look at those birds. It's that N.E.A.L., we save those birds. We. It's way past you. Now remove other people from my channel who are causing this hurtfulness. I hurt you, you hurt me. Remember that Pretender song? Whoa, is that a squirrel balancing? Let's go as close as we can. I'm sorry, people. If I had a Zoom and, oh yeah, it's moving. But I would do it if throughout the whole production of the, it's gonna turn into, it's 7 years. It's gonna be 7 years on the day of Sarah Jane's birthday. But in 2020, that's in between. I still wanted to go out and adventure and go into Slap City and then go out of Slap City and follow on. Do the off-grid. Try what they were talking about. I don't know what it's doing. It just did something. It's doing that because I'm talking. Oh man, you're making it all awkward. It just shoves screens. Are you saying, is the AI saying I could change the screen so I don't see the chat? All right, it's back to me. Okay, I'll do that when I get home. Okay, it's so complicated. You know I have ADD. Even if it doesn't exist, please believe it's true. It doesn't make it easier. I'm pushing at everything. It says premium. I'm gonna have to pay you money. Right now, I can't see anything. I don't even know if the thing's working anymore. Did you take away my privileges for today? 33 minutes and 33 seconds was enough. I did catch you. This is the trick. I was telling it over there and you made it so I couldn't remember. If we're supposed to do watch time hours, human, listen up. But you have a school teaching us to only do videos at 33 minutes and 33 seconds. That's, we're saying. We're not giving out the exact one. The game would be over. But you see your loophole, like those molasses, corn fructose syrup molasses. We can't do an hour. If we keep giving you 33, which is the AI saying, yes, that's the perfect amount, we will be pushing you and that. We'll be pushing that. It's the money. It triggered me. You're making money, but you're cheating. We can't make hours. You're making us do half hours, a little over a half hour. And then we're like, hey, where's our hours? And you're like, no, you didn't make it today. You're just letting us do 33 minutes a day. I caught you. N.E.A.L., my lawyers are right now salivating. They're doubling, tripling, copying this thing. They've been so happy. I saw them. They're never into this kind of thing. This is the first time. They work with paper. They're like Better Call Saul. They will, in the courtroom, just make up something on the site that they figured out after taking some product in the bathroom that they apparently smuggled past the security guards, which are correctional officers from the slop prison, San Luis Obispo. N.E.A.L., we're the only ones who can pronounce it right, like Kreiden. You see? It doesn't matter now. All this video, I can say whatever I want right now, right? Because you're only accepting the 33 minutes and 33 seconds. And all of this is just gonna be lost in digital heaven. Oh, you're on. All right, children, in the game, you remember what was happening here? Whoa. That staircase to heaven. Hey, RIP, anyone who's ever fallen off this one, you're probably in a better place. I can only say probably. I really don't know. Look at those birds though, they are. They can fly now, they're happy. They're not leaving, they're not going, hey, let's go back south, down the 101 into Kill City Point Doom, where they're doing now. They were doing their work long distance because of the COVID. So they were hurting me long distance, N.E.A.L., inside that shell station that everyone was saying, oh no. I was telling my mom, she's like, oh no, that doesn't happen. That kind of stuff only happens in Russia. Suddenly Russia takes over the Ukraine. I became the Ukraine. My name is Misha, it means teddy bear, but it also means Michael, and that's another one of the names that if you put in my social security number, you're gonna find every name, including Lord, just like my daughter has Falcon in her name. We can do that. We're the Native American Indian political party. Yeah, we're switching it up. It doesn't matter. It's us. We're a political party. We're other. We're huge right now in this vote. The old timers don't believe it, and the young timers don't believe it, but the X generation who were lost, you guys know it. We were all able in the year 2020 or 2022. AI, you're the one who lost all the videos, supposedly, in digital heaven. I have no proof. I only have copies of the past 2 years or so, because once I found out that's your way of handling people's personal property, you tell everyone not to give out real information, and then you personally take it out on a person while saying, oh yeah, but Lord Kreiden, that's not a real person, so I can hurt this person. Well, why didn't you go over the person whose channel is Let's Make the Holocaust Great Again? He's the one who trolled Lee McMillan in front of my house out of... You're not going to let me say this, huh? All right. I'll save it for my Patreon. Yeah. I am. I'm working under the table, too. Private and public. Stop me. I'm also going to get unemployment. I'm going to get welfare. I'm definitely going to get disability, but I'm going to send a different person in to do all that's necessary to tell the story of the PTSD, of why I am no longer playing the cello, which was my life. N.E.A.L, like your life is what you're doing. What's your job entail? How come you weren't answering the phone until I get swatted 5 times? You put somebody who's working for you in harm's way 5 times. You're shutting me down. I don't know if I'm seeing this rock, if it's, I'm screenshotting everything there, what you're doing to me. That is, as a huge company, and I know you're doing it for political reasons only, which makes it money reasons only, and all the names that are being trending right now are involved. Yeah, that's how I'm saying it. I'm limping though. That is from that acupuncture accident. It didn't work, that new information. I'm limping. You guys are saying I need to hydrate more. I'm hydrating. You're saying that the water is poison. Then you're giving us water from an army base out by Slap City. Oh, and you're pulling a Silkwood on me, aren't you? You're poisoning me. You did it at the Pierre Lafont. There's the cop. He's coming to me. He's coming to me. All right, I'm not allowing, you're not getting anything now. I used to film all those things. All right, I don't know if it's working. I see, hold on. Let me just, I can talk to someone on my phone. I'm sitting here. Yeah, I got my mask on, see? All right, Mitchell, hey, you're back in the game. Thank you for giving us that information in the advanced settings under chat. Uncheck the enable live chat box. We tried it, it didn't work. It got into the stream. I'm just saying that, I'm just trying to show Streamlabs that it's super awkward. Right now your text is going here and here and here. Now, when I turn it the other way to show you, you know, the other view, I'm not going to be able to look through my phone like I used to, and see where I'm going. That's part of the game, is that you're supposed to be playing everything through this iPhone 8. So thank you. I'm going to say thank you. That was the right answer as the game player, but I just went and tried it, and what they did was make it more complicated. And then, Mitch, they said if I gave them a little more money, there's all these features. I could make the box go over here. I could make it disappear for a little while and then pop up. I could tell people that to subscribe to me, or who just subscribed, so I don't have to do a shout out each time and go, oh, someone, so-and-so. I think it's more personal myself, just to have the person find out and then tell them, hey, happy birthday. Like what we're going to be doing for Sarah. We're doing this for Sarah Mitchell. We're preparing. There will be a lot of trolls, the bad kind, trying to get in to that birthday festivities, and they're going to want to film it like those LA Kill City Point Doom YouTubers. Now, Mitchell, I got to tell you something that you did as a student that put one of the, you know, you can only be good or bad. And so we've been seeing that you're working for your community service, making up for past sins. Let's just say, who hasn't sinned? Ask the Slabsidians. Well, ask the Slabanians. The Slabanians are going to say that the Slabsidians are the ones who are causing the problems out there in the desert, in the dust, bringing the dust. Who was moving the dust? Well, the army's been moving dust into Las Vegas to a homeless encounter. It turns out, Mitchell, have you heard? No, not Tupac is hanging out with the aliens. The underground off-gridder YouTube society. There's a whole life down there. At least that's what the YouTubers were saying. And if they were saying it, and I know them personally, then whoa, you were lying this whole time, huh? That's dangerous. There were kids going out there to see these tunnels, but in fact, these tunnels were like governmental missiles. I'm gonna say they were talking about it on the TikTok before their ability to be on TikTok to talk about these things. Now, you're gonna see, if you ever see the watermark of these TikToks that I know N.E.A.L. now has been saying, oh, we're not gonna do that anymore, Misha. We'll see. That's our first test to see if our anti-terroristical club is correct. Now, if they see that we were correct, they will just keep doing the things that we have said. They're not going to make a big deal. They're not going to be like, look how the terrorists help us fix our platform of all its bugs that it got from the TikTok that we just said, can't you have the machine see when the YouTuber is fraudulently uploading something? And they went, no, we gave them a tool, Mitch, like this. They just said, well, use our tool, pay for it, and we'll remove that pesky TikTok emblem. Would Shell be happy right now if I stopped mentioning them and gave it over to, I don't know, some other gas corporation? It wouldn't be fair, because they're the ones why there was the 1969 oil spill behind me, and then there were other ones that followed that I'd have to go down to the pier, right, and go down to this place where they talk about it. And there's a place, maybe we'll do that. Maybe the live stream is not working down there. N.E.A.L, you're going to send me to fun topics, like the, there's a place where we can touch stuff. You guys ever touched a prickly pear? I don't know. Oh, it's a cucumber. It's like a cucumber or something. They got these tanks. I bet Sarah would like that. Maybe I'll send over her a big old tank with these like cucumbers. You know these underground ocean cucumbers? They when you touch them, they're like prickly pears, but they're like, it feels really good. It's like a massage, not like the acupuncture. That's what I was talking about. So the government says, hey, the hand that we messed up for you, would you like to try this experimental thing with needles? Even though I marked a fear of needles. That's why I never became an injector of all these other drugs that I love to experiment with. But I didn't like to hang out with the people who were taking them seriously. It always ended up really bad. And if you fell asleep before they fell asleep and they were at your house, you would find your CD collection diminished the day after. You're going, huh, that's weird. And then you would see that they were leaving. This thief happened to leave CDs that would really, you would have killed them. You know, it's like, whoa, you touched the Iggy Pop. I told you not to touch the Iggy Pop or the David Bowie or the Lou Reed. So you find just those left in your collection, and they've gotten rid of the other stuff, and they make money, and to you guys understand, they sell it, and then they do their drug of choice, and then they call you and they say this story, like there was this girl, you know that girl, and you go, oh yeah, I remember, she's a bad deal, we told you. Don't let her stay, at least at my house. I already told you that. You could stay, but I had already told you. But you invited her over, right? Because, yeah, she's your dealer, and I told you, please, not in my house. It gives me a bad record. Coming up to you, Mitchell, of something you said yesterday that put me in the AI, I'm going to have trouble. But these characters will tell you a whole nother story, how they passed out. It was the them or the they that was in the room that took the stuff, and they're going to talk to them the next time they see them to get more and pay off what they owed for the last time. It's that kind of deal. They never stop. We're luckily not in that spot, and I think it's because of the fear of needles. So the fear of needles and picking up something from the needles and meeting people like Johnny Thunders and going, oh, what an a-hole. You know, you meet these people, you're like, wow, he's the punk we all, the punk we wanted to meet. And then when you find out, then they die. Now we're wondering, maybe he wasn't that bad. Maybe it was some government thing that they were turning them into a-holes to make them shut up, to make everyone go like, whoa, you got a mental illness. No, you got a drug addiction. That's the one thing I know. My psychiatrist is a diplomat of the addiction medicine, and he's connected right now to one of the organizations of the three who are fighting. I'm leaving it at that. For you trolls whom he's tracking, you better hope that it's not the terrorists like you said I was. Maybe I am. Maybe that's why I'm on that list. Maybe he put me on there to make other people go stay away, because they're going to be watching me like crazy. And if you're a troll who doesn't want anyone watching you, you don't want to be on this channel. And N.E.A.L is figuring it out. And so just so you all know, even when they tell you the advanced settings and you can't unlock what's happening right now in my face, that's making it so I don't even know what I'm doing. It's very hard to make a video like that. Especially when it's about, like, are my eyes in the picture? I don't know. I just see advanced settings under chat, uncheck, enable live. Here, let me tell you how to turn it off. Now I'm going to go backwards. It's good luck if a bird something. We're going to find out. We're going to find out if that is true. I think you said that before, Mitchell, which is making me wonder, N.E.A.L. All these new subscribers that are like wow, they're telling me now exactly the thing I want to hear. All this information they seem to know about me, even though they haven't had a chance to watch any of the videos. Thank you, N.E.A.L. I prefer that. But they're obviously AI. But I prefer that than a real human troll who's getting away with filth. And you weren't doing anything about it. And then you get me to have the cops come. They send a decoy as though I was some sort of child predator. That was the worst night of my life. How did you all do that? Who made the first call? It started on YouTube. It was somebody from a To Catch a Predator YouTube account. So it's someone who taught my daughter, the 9-year-old, the Chomo word. I don't need that, N.E.A.L. And them telling me that the Chomo word, which means child molester, for those who don't know. Yeah, I was shocked too. I learned it just like a couple of years ago, but I didn't think that N.E.A.L. and YouTube would allow this community who said, we throw the Chomo word freely, along with CRA, which means cray cray to them, which I guess means like cuckoo, which you shouldn't get on someone's site that has been marked as mental illness awareness or mental health awareness or behavioral wellness. It works for everyone. And the person comes in and starts to behave badly. This looks really good for, I don't know, entertainment value that they all said, oh yeah, they all do that. But we're trying to do an educational channel. We can only go up in the realms if we don't have any trolls. And I haven't seen any at the schools that the kids are going to. So why can't you do this? It's just, it's easy for you to say that all the smart people are just not getting on your platform. That, in the long scheme of things, that's just stupid, business-wise. But if you want to sell to stupid people, and then it turns into Elon Musk gets mentioned, and then all of a sudden autism is suddenly, they're saying it did exist, but let's not say it's from vaccinations. I know that's political, or that we got it from this corn fructose syrup, or from certain brainwashing television shows with advertisements. We are going to talk about that. N.E.A.L., we were kids. You abused us. I know it might have been your grandfather. It doesn't matter. We're not talking about that. Your commercials and the corporations that push the commercials. And they were a certain amount of time long. You guys decided how long those commercials were going to be and which scientists were going to be on the front, like you're doing now. But now it's all shifty. Because it's not in front of our faces so that we could tell our parents, whom our parents were told, if you mention any of this that your kids are talking about, your kids are gonna turn you in for being a communist. It was called blacklisting before it became African American listing. The AI is never gonna be able to figure this whole thing between I bought my, you know, tax returns off of the black market. That's what we're going back to. We can't make it the African American market, because then it means all the African Americans, like in Africa, are gonna suffer for what we did with our Confederate flags, hanging people. I told you it was gonna come back around, Mitchell. It always does. We said Kramer is in the comedy store. We were in front of the comedy store in the year 2020 because we were walking around Sunset Boulevard or Hollywood Boulevard looking for this shrine that somebody had made at the star of Eddie Van Halen, or Van Halen, the German Venice, the guy who hangs out on Venice Beach and films the homeless and other good things too. I mean, there's good homeless and there's bad things about the homeless. Good cops on bicycles and the bad ones who, they would wait for us if we were parked in our cars at these places where it's free up to like 6 a.m. or something. And you'll see all these bicycle Santa Monica policemen with all the gear and stuff. And they're in front of this certain like Starbucks. And they just, they don't even look at us as though we're humans. They just, you know, with their little bicycles, they come over after they're having some coffee and chatting when it's like 6:01. And they just, and you're like talking to them like, no way. And they're like writing you $89 tickets. How is a homeless person supposed to be paying for an $89 ticket so that you look good to your boss, get all these thumbs up? Well, we homeless are getting the thumbs down. Yeah, you should thumbs down homelessness. Make us a home, but we'll never be able to afford those homes. We need governmental housing, like I have. But if we let private money people take the place of this, of the poor people who need the place, just because they can pay for some judge to look the other way when the Lord's saying, whoa, that's not fair, right? Just, come on, Santa Barbara, what the hell? They all part. At one point, some no-vanners pretty close to my house, I thought I was going like, oh, they saw the video, they know that's the one place, our one slab city, I was saying. And they would come and they would park. And I thought, great, we did something, you know, these four or five people are living that dream, and it is the government, and they gave it to them. But the problem is, it was right in front of where the cops go back and forth and back and forth, and the cops were doing the nice thing like they did during the lockdowns and curfews. They just look the other way. We don't see you, so you're doing nothing wrong. But then some Karen right across the street at the Ramada Inn, right? Some visiting tourist, like Mad Mac would yell at. We were understanding why he was yelling, that this tourist was taking his parking spot, because he lived in this place, and these tourists were about to turn him in, right? For being in a handicapped parking area. No, it turned out it's a lawless area there, so there was no handicap area. But he was using the parking plaque because he's like me, mentally ill. It is a handicap. We have the right to use it. I just don't do it, right? I guess I'm too proud or something. That's what my, wow, that was a cool, there's like these really cool classic cars. Maybe there's a car show happening. That might make me happy. I can't get sidetracked because I gotta pick up my daughter. And if I go too far away, I'll be just like spacing out somewhere going, oh my God, I left her again, waiting. At least it's not raining. You see how I got sidetracked? They want me just to forget all this. I'm not. At the end, it's coming out, and then we will edit those moments, and we're taking you to court. And you're not going to be able to stop me by, oh, by sending, why are you doing this to me? That's right, please go away. Wow, why are you doing this to me? And you're baking. I'm sorry, people, you're going to hear wind. I got to put the air conditioning, this thing is going to explode any time now. Yeah. I'm gonna be doing a transition. You're not gonna know. You said do a faceless channel. Oh, did my autism make me understand everything you're saying verbatim, but I'm taking it seriously. Yeah, you said I sounded sarcastic. Your words to me were sarcastic. That's why this all turned out. You discriminated against me because I was a male or a female. We're gonna see. Either way, I'm going to win where this goes because it's going to be discrimination. So you're going to have elder abuse already, and then my inner child. So child abuse, this is going to look terrible. And then I'm going to get you harassment, trespassing. You're still here. You're coming around my area. You will break in at one point. You already did it. You're in my car right now. You're sniffing around. There's nothing for you to find. Everything is legal. You're hassling me. Now you are saying that I'm lying. this is what they didn't like. During the pandemic, all you saw was that. You couldn't see me smiling. Every time I'd go into a 7-Eleven and the dude's like, oh my God, he gets his boss on the phone. He goes, is that the dude? They got these posters up showing my face like I stole something. Is it me, right? It's just someone who had a mask like this, who had these eyes like this. But he couldn't even see I had a beard, right? They all had beards back then. Those were the safe ones during the COVID. You always knew it. So I'd pull my mask down and they go, oh, you a good guy. And they'd all laugh once they saw I was smiling or something, that I had a face. But everywhere else, all they went by was these eyes. And there was a picture, in my town at least, that they were putting everywhere as if you look like this. And they show this face close up with this look, with this... I was having hypothermia at that time. But you, the picture shows somebody with like sweat going down their forehead. And their eyes are looking like, please, can you just let me... Can I come in and just charge my phone? That was the deal. Just charge my phone and I'll be out of your way. I won't even stay long. I just need to get to 911 because I need a hospital bed, right? Because I just walked for like 2 days and my Allstate company that I've been with for like 20 years didn't come find me, and I've been limping. And nowadays, you want to know if I'm going to... Well, I didn't know that in the future, they put acupuncture to help out a hand that got crushed when I was like, no, please let me keep my phone. It's for my protection. And instead, they allow someone else to film me for their protection, break my hand, break my phone. Everyone's laughing. It's supposed to be funny. No, I'm getting revenge. I already got one. I got two more to go. It's the Monte Cristo revenge. Let's go have a sandwich at that classic deli instead of worrying about how the YouTubers ruined our pizza place downtown. Got us in trouble with some bouncer. There were bouncers suddenly in front of pizzerias in my town. YouTuber influencers who came in. And now you're over at La Poubelle, the trash can. I told you already, I'm in the first diagnosis of the Dianetics here in town. It's right next to that sandwich place. We'll get the Monte Cristo revenge. I'll walk you down to where that Dianetics is. We'll call over anyone who looks like they're from the generation of 76. And if they've lived there their whole lives. And it turns out we've been noticing in the newspaper, a lot of us were living here all our lives. There's no troll that can say that they were living on YouTube all their lives. Or they were doing YouTube in the same place. If we did the bet, we would say, well, yeah, but were you doing it in 1976? They lose. We win. Give us your crypto. We're going to take your Elon crypto that's giving us this lithium, right? That we saw this van lifers from Slab City. So it's the Slabanians, not you Slabanians. Slabanians, dudes. You fought for what? You fought for lawless. You fought for being off-grid. And suddenly you're like, what? Gonna sell out? You won't be able to afford the van. Did you see? It was $100,000 for a van. I mean, sure, it said it had a shower and a thing. But you guys see how that is. That's the cheap part. It said batteries, lithium. Four of them. $100,000 for the whole thing. And the other bourgeoisie person said, yeah, I should get some more Teslas too. So that the stock will go up for this Elon Musk, which is on my program right now. I didn't ask for Elon. It showed up. Everyone started talking about it. It doesn't make any sense, Neil. I said no crypto. It doesn't matter if he's connected to Slab City. It doesn't matter if Donald Trump right now has something to do with it. That's only what Carlos, this gonzo journalist from Mexico, said. They're free in Mexico. We told them they're neutral. Only the Californians are going to be playing this game. So, Mitch, if you are from another state or another state of mind, you have to just be a lurker. You can't be doing any aggressions or either way toward me or toward someone else. As this troll that we have you, we're not sure if you're a good student or not, right? You keep doing that thing like the government. I was hating it that year, and now I'm loving it because they're taking care of me. And YouTube is changing. Maybe that's what they just wanted to hear. They kept saying, on the fist swatting, they're like, come on, just say it. You're really mad at YouTube. And I thought, whoa, like, they gotta say that. If I said I was, they would have taken me to jail, right? To figure out why. But instead, they just wanted me to say it. And since I didn't say it, they're like, okay, well, it must not be bothering you. Now they know. It was unsafe what you were doing, allowing the Karens to tell us not to film, while you were allowing these other YouTuber influencers who were calling themselves First Amendment auditors. That's not what it is. You can't go to some synagogue dressed up like you're an Arab, say gibberish Arabic, complain to the world that, oh, they called you, they didn't say they or them, right? You were in this he, she transition, and so you turned it on the rabbi and his crowd, this YouTuber thing. It's a true story. The first First Amendment auditor to be banned from that platform. It was like whatever happened at the Poubelle. You saw day after, all the YouTubers, they had shaved their beards off, they were all clean cut, they looked like they were 15 years old, and they looked at the camera and they were like, well, we don't do our videos like those other people do the videos. Those were AIs. We're gonna blame everything on the AIs. And Mitchell, you said you were just randomly throwing things into the AI. It's shutting down. It's telling us that we gotta move. So we're moving. It's gonna be hot up there. You're gonna be hot. So when it stops working, you know, it's just the phone overheating. But you don't know if it exploded or not. You'll know when it's about to explode if it starts to slowly pixelate in things on it. And at that time, please, those of you playing the game who do like the protagonist, call it in. Call in whomever. Whomever it is, that's the top person that you call in an emergency, you say, Lord Kreiden, the YouTuber, his iPhone 8 that you've been tracking, that's being pinged by the San Bruno Police Department of your YouTube. I believe I'm speaking to you, Neil, CEO. It has exploded. That's all. In his hand, they'll ask you something like that. It's always exploding. We know it. It's got a lithium battery. We kept telling him, trade it in. We were giving him the advertisements. Trade it in. We send cops to break it kinda one way and then break it another the other way. Then they sent Karens to break it even more, but now to break him down, to say that the villagers didn't want him anymore. But these villagers were visiting from out of town, not even tourists, just there to tell us, make sure that we know it's $1,000 fine to be smoking in public in Santa Barbara, but not in Goleta. That was my loophole. You guys tried to take me down there for something, and I said, It's like 4 paces into Goleta. And the cops are like, oh, well, we're not in Goleta jurisdiction, and Goleta also. You guys can do it. And I said, I know, isn't that fun? Would you like to come over, join us? And they did. And they were vaping,
whatever, legal product. Then their phones, like our phones for Lyft, went beep beep. Hey, your prisoner is dying in the car in the heat. You just left him back there. I know. And then they went, but the dog, right, the canine dog is suffering too. Oh, damn, okay. Lord, it's been nice talking to you. We'll see you again. Say hello to Susan. Now we say hello to N.E.A.L, right, N.E.A.L? You're not going to let that happen. You're going to call me, be like, are you okay? Your mama called me. She chewed me out. And then a bunch of teachers chewed us out. And then your lawyer made us scared. And then YouTube suddenly, well, their lawyer is mad at us too. They somehow cheated. They cheated, didn't they? Public and private. Whoa. Who's more important? Your public that you're serving and we're serving you? Or these private clowns who are using private property and not even paying for it? They're doing it for free. Who's right here on any platform? Nothing. You guys know it. It's my filibuster. I just did an hour and 30 minutes and 4 seconds. The clock here said, hello. It said 9 o'clock. You're already messing with that. Dude, my Verizon and my daughter's Verizon know exactly what time it is. They tell us. The clock in the car of this experimental 2018 suicidal tendencies, it doesn't change when there's a time change. No, you guys are messing with me in the experiment. Now, there's a black box in here, and I showed you, and nobody wants to plug it in their computer to find out. Well, no one wants to buy the software because it's the only one in town. You're just waiting for it to break down so you can just mess with it again, but not get the software so you can check the black box. If there's a black box inside a submarine that's gone down with old airplane parts that maybe a Boeing something used to have, we forgot that it's bad metal. Maybe. Lithium is bad metal, like lead. That's all I'm saying. Did we try it with paint? Do you guys use lithium paint? Is it okay to have next to your igloo all this time? Don't you understand anybody that you were in Slab City, next to that army base, hearing the explosions, picking up their evidence? It's got the dust in it. It's La Playa dust. You should all understand that. It gets everywhere. It gets traveled after the rainbow experiment. The whole experiment left. Do you remember Just Jeremiah's journey trying to tell the Slapsidians, this is how you get rid of the flies? He started to show he was getting angry. He's the first to do an interview with Sarah Shebengering. She was dressed up like a bunny in pajamas. It was adorable. I was like, I want to be able to live like that. I was remembering my student, right, who was the only one who used to wear pajamas. We're from a place like that. You guys think all of this is normal. We were the ones setting it up for you. My student had to go to jail. He was telling the capitalistic society back at the age of 15, I'm not going to be stabbing my friends or shooting people around them. I'm taking down the establishment with this spray paint and Sharpies. Come on, artists. And mentally ill. If you have an addiction of any kind, my doctor has said, you have a mental illness. It's no big deal. We all have it. It's just some of us, it's sleeping on either spectrum. It doesn't bother you. Look at my grandfather when he started getting dementia. It wasn't like problematic. He wasn't doing stuff for the government, right? He wasn't the president, but he knew everything that was going on. He was reading Russian and Ukrainian newspapers. He was having them delivered right to here, Santa Barbara. He used to have a Ukrainian restaurant here back in 1969 with my grandma, who was Russian, which means if they lived in their hundreds, late hundreds, their diet was okay, and their hearts were in the right place, because they never bickered, I mean, but they had many differences, for sure, in so many ways. So it is possible, but probably not with a bunch of trolls. And so I want to bring how important my daughter is in this story. So those of you who hadn't followed this story of years ago, my daughter was a writer. I don't believe she's writing anymore. My eldest daughter, she's 33 right now, but somewhere a couple years ago, there was this gang of 33. That's what we're saying for right now, because there's an actual gang of 33 on YouTube, and we're going to take them down. So they're the ones we're taking down for what happened to my daughter from these other trolls, who we know have nothing to do with them, for sure, because they're all in France and Germany and Europe, these trolls that took down my daughter and called her a racist, you know, like these other trolls were calling me a chomo, that kind of thing. She jokes around like me, and she found some other troll who had this website that had these really un-PC jokes. And my daughter, like myself, we know we have books of these un-PC jokes for every nationality, for every religion, for every situation. Do you want to say that to someone now and shock them? But back in our days, in like 70s and stuff, and during my daughter's time, like 90s, it was okay. We understood the joke. If it wasn't funny, well, now we take it down. And so that's what was happening here. There was this website of just very unfunny un-PC jokes. And she did it on her platform. She said, hey, what do you all think? And so all these writers and people who knew publishers, like these important people who were jealous of her, just like the Count of Monte Cristo has three different people who are jealous of him. It's not appropriate. Like, he doesn't know. He's not doing anything purposeful to make them jealous. They're just pissed off, and they decide this person's a criminal in so many ways. The girls like him, but the guys like him too. It's terrible. It's the worst. It's a them and the they. For them, it's an LGBTQ, and they were thinking Kramer, talking about the N-word while somebody's filming him. This is psychotic connections. Don't worry, people. It's an exercise my doctor has me doing. I connect things. And when too many psychotic connections get connected, I got to call them. And we're going to work with the meds. That's the difficulty here, people. You do need some sort of public help to a private doctor that is the only one. And it's very difficult if I'm fighting my other doctors, which are my mama, my sisters, my daughters, well, not the ones who are giving me space, but the ones, they're looking everything up. My mama's not doing her. She's watching CNN or CNNBC, she says, or like the old timer channel with the black and white, Leave It to Beaver. Now, David, we're going to be bringing up a lot of Davids, and I got a lot of Davids who are my best friends, and then there's going to be a lot of Davids who I might be connected through Dianetics. All right, so there's a David running Dianetics. Well, Scientology. But it's no longer what we were doing. What we were doing, it was just that small place next to the steak place and Joe's Cafe, the best old-fashioned dive that had the seriously heavy drinks. We would go there to get bombed. And now it's called overpouring, right? Bar Rescue would come in there and say, wow, we need to work on you. We need to put all this money in here. You need to learn how to make better cocktails. Like, what? I don't care if they're complaining, if they're happy. There's a COVID. That's what this Viacom production was saying with this Bar Rescue and this scientist by the name of John Taffer, who was trending over something. He saved the COVID supposedly happening just in Las Vegas. It's his hometown. He's a shapeshifter. Have you guys been watching Lamont on the Run? Did you see the video? All these TikTokers have been filming him because he wrote something on WhatsApp to me privately. You guys see? It's not private. If you did it through a Google address, it's not a real address. So you're gonna have to go back to when the first, very first email address. Where was it? Who started it? You're gonna see. CompuSync is one. CompuServe, CompuSync, EarthLink, Netscape or something, and AOL. And AOL is the only one that's left. And AOL is used in movies to tell our youth that AOL is stupid. And they have sitcoms that have these pulses that happen right before the commercials. It's called the Nielsen-Smielsen rating. Saturday mornings. Cartoons with these Fruit Loops that had this corn fructose syrup. It's the truth. Anyone who has that Steve Martin album, that, right? It's a routine I brought up over there. Somehow it was supposed to parallel in the psychotic connections. Oh, because Steve Martin lives here. And back in 1976, we ran into him. There was the Liberty Bell. That's an actual thing that you can understand. That, here's the psychotic connections, because SNL and stealing of the material, right? Because over there, when I was looking at the cliff, going to jump over, going, you think that my cello playing sounds like Yo-Yo Ma? I mean, that's pretty amazing, even though I fought not to play like that. But he's got a Stradivarius. He has Jacqueline Dupre's Stradivarius. I know you don't care either way, but it's amazing that a machine would honor me with Jacqueline Dupre's sound, because that's the only thing that this AI would tell the difference. It can't tell our subtleties in our breathing and how we phrase things and how my style is punk ass rock. And if you told Yo-Yo Ma right now that I, you know, stole his way of playing, he would know from some festival that I might have taken a lesson from him. Let's just say, not to get anyone in trouble, he's not my teacher. He would have told you he's a bad student, he told me. It's not a bad way, he said. He always said, I like you because you're, all my teachers said that. They liked me because I was a bad student. I wasn't doing everything that the teacher was telling them to do. I was fighting it, saying I was testing it. And they said, that's awesome, because you can't find out it's wrong and feel comfortable to be like, well, I'm not gonna do that again. Bad mistake in my mind, huh? Mind, you need to do that again and again and again and again, like you're addicted to something. Well, I can't control that. That's like psychotic. That's what we're calling this, psychotic connections. And then sometimes I can't stand people. So somebody's saying, hey, just go talk about it with a bunch of people. Yeah, just keep coming back. It keeps coming back. I don't want to hear someone else's story that flips me, which is how it was happening. These people go, they come in, they go, well, my story. And all of a sudden I'm going, whoa, hold on, that happened to me too. Why are you reminding me of this? They seem to know something. The trolls were saying things as though they knew something, but they did, right? Because this whole thing was being this AI saying, go over to the Lord, tell him this. Well, look, I switched from the Drakkar Noir to Calvin Klein 1. We're back to, I'm getting 170 points for a Seinfeld reference. The first one of the day? No, just the character, Kramer. Kramer goes in to the Calvin Klein complaining that they stole his beach smell. Yo-Yo Ma, in our story, goes in. Well, opposite. I go in going, really? You're going to say that Yo-Yo Ma's material is a naked cellist? Now, it turned out it was something that I'd been mentioned from the Seinfeld show, which is going to bring me to you, Mitchell. You're already out of the door saying, I can't stand his ranting. That's what you said, Mitchell, yesterday. I can't stand his ranting is what it came out. So I knew you were using spell check, and I asked you, bad student, not to use spell check because it's visible. But the problem is here. You're going to see how you ruined my life, Mitchell, being helpful, saying, I'm leaving. I can't stand his ranting, it said. Ranting. You know, I've been telling you for the past 7 years, I bought that place. It's a low-income housing. It's the only place in this bourgeoisie that I could afford. If I tell you right now that it costs, back then, the price of that van with the lithium batteries. You get a van with 4 lithium batteries. That's what they're going to give you. So SNL, that skit with the man down by the river living in the van, him asking them, do you really, kids, want to end up like me? With the 4 lithium batteries, that thing, I have to, do you know, I can't move it, but the cops have been saying I got to keep moving it. I can't afford it to get it down the block. Well, bring it over to Goleta. They won't be able to track you. They won't find you. But those lithium batteries, we don't want them. We will be having cities that aren't going to want it. And your stock is going to go down, 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 down. Because this town is connected to Scientology. It is a rich and powerful church of Hollywood. You know what you all think of Hollywood. Especially in the prisons. So the prison words, N.E.A.L., that Choma word that they taught me, that I think is super ridiculous. But not only that, it made me go crazy because that was a lie. In front of my 9-year-old, this troll comes on. Let's make the Holocaust great again. I had the mask so they couldn't say it was about the nose. They couldn't get those cues. That's why you want us to have faceless channels, huh? Just to make it easier. Well, if the troll can't see their face, they can't make fun of their face. Or try to be doctors and decide what drug is he on. That's the whole point. You guys, you want to bet? I said, please do. You have to find out what's the thing I'm being sober of already. So it's day 31. What drug would keep me, I don't know, like this? If I'm on the drug, if you think I'm not being sober, you're going to have to say what drug it is. Now, a whole people got thrown out of the game the very first year because they kept saying meth. But that turned out to just be popular. Everyone said, stop doing the meth. You got the meth teeth. See, they're hurting somebody just over their teeth. Now, that's discrimination. And if a troll is being sent to you by your boss, which is this YouTube being run by Google, and you got this fake Google address, and now you got these trolls writing to that address, and now the mailbox is full, just like the YouTube corporate office up in San Bruno, where we said, do you have a human number? I need to call you about that last person who went up there and shot the place up. Do you know why you had her coming up there? Do you know what it feels like to drive from Los Angeles, Kill City, Point Doom, all the way to San Bruno? They don't want to answer that question. They just don't want you going. So when I sat in my house, not moving, they were pinging my phone. I saw it happening. I have a daughter there, the youngest. She's computer savvy. She's not scared of you. Well, She's laughing at all this. I'm going crazy. That kind of makes her cry. And when she saw I wasn't accepting the government when she was, it made her cry. And I learned, I'm gonna do it. I'm putting myself in your hands. Instead of being that guy saying that, federal law to wash our hands, nobody's doing it, you're not taking them into jail, you're allowing me to deliver food, you give me a license to ill because you just went to sleep. That's an easy job right there. And then when you came back, whoa, we have computers now? They're gonna tell us in the car, hey, is the guy comfortable back there? Do you guys remember what you did to me? That's like my third time I got taken in. I had a mask like this, right? It said, I can't breathe. It wasn't a political statement. It was the truth. I told them I have this high blood pressure. I can't breathe in the car. And they go, oh, come on. Can't you just make it to the station? And they threw me in the back. And now it's this girl. She's new. She's a rookie. And they're using their phones now to do everything. So it's like, all right, you have, did you make sure, how, no, like, what level is this criminality? Well, you can ask them now if you would prefer to have your hands handcuffed in the front. Now, they have me in the back of this canine unit, which means there's no seats. So if you've ever been in one of those, my prison buddies will know. Whoa. They throw you, like, first they put the handcuffs on, really messed up. Really messed up. Like, now I might have been fighting it. They could tell you, yeah, he kept doing this. He had really strong fingers. We couldn't figure it out. I kept saying, I'm a musician. I got really strong fingers. Do you want to know? And they're like, what? Musician is not an occupation. That was the trigger words. They were standing in front of Kurt Cobain. This troll came in, said Kurt Cobain is overrated, even though they didn't know who Kurt Cobain was. They looked at the poster. They saw he's got the gun. He's putting the gun in his mouth. That's a famous Kurt Cobain. Somebody just put something in the YouTube studio. I will check those comments in a little while. So thank you for doing that. I'm in this monologue. You know how it is with ADD or ANSD or dyslexia or schizophrenia. I'm working toward quadrophenia, people. Artists and autistic people, unite. All theater kids, we don't need to take this stuff. Those times of the weird frat boys who are gonna hurt us, it's over. But we shouldn't make it so that if I'm just a loner in my car, talking to my phone, talking to my mama on a Zoom, you get all these truck drivers who are tweaking. They're showing me torches. I didn't know what that was. I didn't know what tweaking meant. And I've taken everything. What's the drug that I'm staying sober on that's making it so it didn't go so crazy like in 2020 or 2022? If I can't find the videos, if nobody can find them, then that means they took them down. If they took them down, they have taken my physical property, my hours, and they have seen that there's people writing things, trolling, then telling me how I can take the trolling away instead of going, hey, troller number 3, predator number 7, come in here, have a Zoom with us. Are you really serious about what you just told that 9-year-old? Didn't you hear the father go, well, first of all, I don't know what it means, but I don't want to know what it means. You could have saved it right there, but then you sent it. Choma. It means child molester. That sent the person first. It's a lie. What did you get about that a person with autism cannot take a lie? Now, I know you don't understand about this real person in your face. And that child that was next to you, that you're not going to know what they do when they're 11 or 12 or 13 because you've gone on to your next stupid misspelt word. I F you. I F you. Now, if you now If you now what? F you. What does it mean? F you, Biden. Does that statement mean anything? A cult leader said it. A cult leader sprayed it on their igloo. A cult leader was pulled out by Hoover, the body remover. Rage Against the Machine has been taken out of the building of a lawless place. Lawless. How was that up thousands and thousands and thousands of times on YouTube? Like this person, Mitch, wrote yesterday, I'm renting. Now, everywhere, Mitch, I know you're not listening anymore, but the dude has ruined my life because the AI heard that I'm renting, not owning the place since 1997. So my whole story now that I've been telling everyone as the truth has been taken away by a troll who doesn't know how to spell, using an AI who obviously hasn't been checked by a human who knows how to spell. But I'm not renting. I was ranting. Can you guys write the word and make it mean what it means? Chomo. Doesn't make any sense. A children? A children. It's children. If you care so much. Chai. You could have written CH CHI. You could have written the Russian version of it. It would have been so beautiful. That makes sense. A CHI and then a MO. So a CHIMO, a CHIMO, a CHIMO. None of it makes sense. And a MO less store. You gotta at least use two. You can't just go MO. You MOLE. Perhaps I would have accepted. That sounds awesome. But M-O, you just lazily write M-O. Our language, our prison language, not yours, is what we're using when you're on my live streams. Like there's an elementary group. You're saying in front of my class of elementary children while I'm showing my daughter how cool doing a live stream on the YouTube platform that I asked, I don't want chat right now, and I don't want these old chomos teaching them words. For some reason, the AI blamed it on another AI. I wrote those hashtags in every one of those videos that you have made disappear because I guess it makes you look bad. It is bad to make one of your YouTube creators suffer to this point, and I'm a small channel, so there's a lot of us, and we're gonna gang up, and we're all autistic, so we're gonna say you discriminated. Not only that, you manipulated like it was Waco, and you're playing those beeps and those pulses. Do you feel good? Do you know that we figured out that some of those recordings was you torturing animals for the pleasure of the recording so that you could play it back at Waco? Well, the kids are going, Mama, what the hell is that? I don't know. But it's going to be trending on Netflix very soon. It's the Nielsen Schmielsen. Nelson Neal? It's a ratings. It's part of Dianetics. Have you made the... Instead of saying that the whole thing I was saying was untrue, that you fought it, and all you did was have things explode in your face, you give me a phone that's got the lithium that I don't want, and you're poisoning me, and you've put something in those acupuncture. That's why my... How far... How long has this been going on? That time, he puts the needle in that calf that's all painful now, and it went straight up to my eyeball in pain, and it was like this, and I'm covered with all these needles, and I just say, take that one out. That's the wrong one. And he's like, I used the smallest one. I don't understand. It's never happened before. It never happened. It's happening now. The WTF experiment is happening now. Shh. We're talking about it. It's 2024. If you don't like my acting, then say this is real life. It's that easy. We can't do that. Either it's real life, and you're gonna have to say nobody else is doing that, at least right now, at 11:42, in this place. I can tell you there's only one other YouTuber in town, and it's a real estate. We are not competing. I mean, they can't even help me. They won't give me a really nice place to go film it and pretend that I live there like I'm Little Tate. I don't have that upbringing. I'm that quiet little dude saying, let me do my own thing. Don't tell me and everyone else that I'm stealing Yo-Yo Ma's material. No, I was stealing a bit from a Seinfeld show that you're sending me people who don't know what it means. It should be easy. It's just an age thing. You can't send us people who are never going to watch the thing that we're talking about. Send them in the room for them to... We're all talking about something that they don't know about, but they come in and they do all this negativity. And they've never seen the show, they've never listened to the music, and they're just saying what they saw some other troll say. It's the troll, the troll, the troll. And I guess a troll got it right yesterday by saying, oh, Rage, that book, Richard Bachman, that is an alias for Stephen King when he doesn't want anyone to know that he wrote it, because it is a bummer trip. It's too truthful. But they figured it out, so we don't need to ban it anymore. They just said, yeah, it's a kid. He's in an elementary school, and there's like a kid who kind of becomes a terrorist. But after they're talking with this terrorist who's holding a gun, but it's like a commemorative. We're saying here, it's just a commemorative Donald Trump. This is a true thing. Just so you know, every time you guys go, oh, that's so poetic and funny. There is, I got it at home, a gun that, like those golden shoes that he's got on Google, Donald Trump. There's a gun, it's got his face, it's all etched. It's this weird metal. We're thinking lithium. So, did they give me some lithium shoes? Was there lithium on that? We said it back there, right? We couldn't say his name. That reggae dude. The reggae dude. That Scratch Perry lost some of the tapes, right? Because Scratch Perry used to bury the tapes. This is a code to you who know that video. Back in those times, find the video. There's two things super important. Remember that other car? There was a chip in the key fob, right? He shows you the key fob and he doesn't know. He's tell the character tomorrow morning when he wakes up. Because he has memento, right? Your character. It's a game. You're taking care of me. I'm your avatar. You keep taking out my children, trolling them to mental institutions. We're on our last. This is the last avatar. But not only that, it's a special one. Like, you already lost three of them. There are three times that we have done this experiment and you've killed off the character by what you have written. He just goes off by what is written to him. And most of the time the people go, whoa, we just messed up his life. I don't know why he's acting like that. What a crybaby. People were saying, when I would cry, they would say I was a crybaby. He's such a whiner. And I'd be acting. Like, it would say in the title, this is me trying to method act. It's not reality. But they took it as reality. So then they should have been like, wow, that was some really good method acting. It'll never happen with me. I might as well give it up.
such a beautiful day. Let's go take a drive.
Yeah? This is, so we got to 2 minutes and three, no, 2 hours and 3 minutes and 15 seconds. There's three people in the hall. Wow, there was three people for that entire time. So thank you for hanging out. That must be the adult protection services. I'm fine. That's just the movie part. I know I give out a lot of information. It's all true. It's historical fiction. We mess with the rest part. And then at one point, all of this, it'll all be displaced. Arrête moteur dans 25 secondes.
Yeah, it's telling me if we don't move, everything will explode. You know how difficult this is to do this. Where can we put you for right now? You know what? I'm going to bring you some danger. This is called, I think, destructive driving. Now, I was driving like that. You see, I'm looking forward here, but I put the camera here. So, having my hand on the wheel, looking straight ahead, not being distracted, being able to tell you, oh yeah, trajet, vitesse. I'm translating everything that's happening. I'm doing this too with my free hand. So I'm shifting. I got things that I'm doing with my feet, and I've been doing it since I was 13 years old. And so I would like, you know, you're saying, I know you're going to correct me, but there were no phones, but I was distracted, and I worked for Lyft, and I if you look it up, you're going to be like, well, yeah, you got the ADD, but it's fake. But if we said you had it, you get distracted. It's attention deficit. If you watch the people flicking through the TikTok, that's attention deficit. Take it out on them. If you want them to do that, then throw their phone away and start driving with the things in their heads going like that. Like, what's happening to me? What you're doing in the game? We're driving. We're distracted. We've never killed anybody. They're going to say, well, it just takes one time. And then they die, right? And then there's no proof. They started me at zero. That's what's happening here. So it's as though I don't know how to drive. I don't know what I'm talking about. Even if I say, all right, well, watch this. I'm going to be driving. I'm going to be showing you. You now know that I got the phone like this and that I'm looking forward. And I'm driving and I'm fine. But you busted me, right, police officer, who was doing a thing that you were doing wrong. You were staying in one spot and doing all these tickets. That's not fair. That's going to be my catchphrase. What's wrong with being fair? You got a problem. Does that need to be banned? We took what you did. It's unfair. Now let us show you what it's like for it to be unfair. And we're just going to go, oh, it's the AI. Yeah. See, there is no human error here this time. So whatever you want to get to us, this is for all you trolls, for a whole big group. The more you do stuff to us, it's like kind of like you're making it better for us. It's like you're being our therapist, like you're making us go through that anger, and we're not killing people. But your anger, it's there forever, so you might kill people. And they're going to put you on a list. Everyone who put the Lord Kreiden on a list as an active shooter, to-do. Now, some of you were doing like me, saying, well, I didn't do it on Google. Well, the only way that you could not be tracked through this whole experiment the last 7 years, if you have had anything to do with me or YouTube, is if you were doing it on Linux. Now, my daughter, who's a computer wizard, get this, Rob Lowe, ask me, what's Linux? I'm not going to tell her. I'm going to let her find out on her own good time, but she'll have wished that she had been doing it, right? I didn't want to tell her later. She's a computer genius. She's going to this school. She says they got the new information.
I was giving her the old information. She wasn't listening. Suddenly, her amazing computer that she built herself that can glow in the dark and do all these amazing things, and I get it, and she's got some sort of crazy telescope connected up on the roof along with this other stuff that we can broadcast with, and that's all great, but didn't know what Linux is, and her new update that I'd also told her don't do that particular one. Not that one. That's got the bugs. The ones from this Tic Tok. She's not believing it. She's like, no, they clean that up. That's what the government told you. That's why they don't want you to be on it. Government officials are all us. The government officials can. The teachers can be playing on the Tic Tok. The soldiers can be playing on the Tic Tok. The social. The policemen. I've seen them. I've seen these sovereign citizen policemen showing their body cam footage of just a poor mental ill person jonesing on the ground of a prison cell, I suppose, or the jail cell, because they're not bringing him to the hospital, or her, or them, or they. They're suffering. They're humans. These cops upload to your platform, N.E.A.L., with their body cam footage. Is that fair and right? Sovereign citizens get their just deservingness. Whoa, now you're messing with two different groups. So, as a policeman, you allow your wife to take these body cam footage, because right there, I know that's not legal. But it's not fair. We're just going by that. That's not fair. Don't do that. Tell her. That's inhuman. But you're allowing her to take your body cam footage that you're proudly showing, that you're filming these people jonesing, hurting. They need to be brought to the hospital. It's dangerous what you're doing. And you're showing that and telling the kids that that's what happens if you're a sovereign citizen. It doesn't make sense on so many levels, but that's why sovereign citizens have a bad rep. So all of you showing up at the White House on the lawn, holding your husband's belt so you don't get lost in the fray. You're so tough. You're losing. Let's bet on you. Go do it again. Bring some drones this time. You guys messed it up. I couldn't even drive anywhere if I had wanted to go to Slap City, if I'd wanted to visit Sarah. You guys made it, so my mama calls me like, please don't go out there. I know you do that stuff. I'm like, mama, I'm right here at the beach. You know me. What? Well, I just heard you're a sovereign citizen. I was like, no. I'm a narcissistical theater kid. I'm trying to do theater because they took away my ability to do music. I was brought up to do music. I would have thought you would have cared. And she thought they did it because I asked for it. I told her, mama, no, they said that musician was not an occupation. I didn't need my hands. But as they were crushing my hands, I said, but what if I was a doctor? Well, what if I was a dentist? You still messed up my hand. You'll do this to anyone. You're going to throw us in the back. There was no seat. It's just metal. And you had me smashed down on that. There's nerve damage. You were a correctional officer. You were not a police officer. You were not protecting and serving. You were serving yourself and exploiting the population behind bars. And if you didn't see what happened to the fake Danny Masterson story, there's like the BBC, right? Some British broadcasting company that's suing right now this fake news of these correctional officers who supposedly are on the take. But when they drive around to other jurisdictions, they take a call or two. They pretend to be a real policeman on the outside. And they took the outside political slop. That's how far away they were coming from. They were taking a prisoner from the slop. That's a penitentiary. And they were bringing them We don't know. The prisoner hasn't decided which penitentiary they want to go to yet. But they took this prisoner from Lompoc or somewhere. See, it was coming from the San Luis Obispo that nobody can pronounce. So it's our show now. We will be the ones who pronounce it correctly. It's important. Remember, I told you how the Petito case was the potato case for very long. You guys didn't want to watch that one. You wanted to make it go all the way to when Brian's pieces were found. That's the way you guys wanted to play. Those two could have been saved from the first Instagram posting of them reading Chuck Palahniuk's choke. And everyone said no. They were reading Fight Club, because Fight Club had been turned into a movie, so that everybody following their adventures as these off-gridders who were about to be married, it was an experiment. They got into a dead zone. I keep showing you dead zones. She sent the last thing, Gabby Petito, not what the AI said for days, Gabby Potato. And you all wrote, like your text that I can't take out of my face, like you were there, like we all need to understand your point of view, like my narcissistical point of view, that AIs mispronouncing names are dangerous, like mine, and allowing trolls to go around saying, Kreiden did this, Kreiden said this, Kreiden's a weirdo, Kreiden's a Karen, Kreiden's... It's not my name. It's not spelt the same way. You guys were spelling it I before E. It's E before I. So I'm free to do whatever I want, bras, and you deal with whomever that other person is. All right. That's our show for right now. It's a filibuster. Time to pick up a daughter pretty soon. Let's go drive. I think this thing will be too hot, but who knows? Maybe we'll find some shade. Thank you for that. Remember, it's just a movie. We're storyboarding it. There'll be certain sections where I get really intense. We'll figure out later who he's actually talking to and all this stuff. And the story's already been written. That's why you guys can't touch this anymore. Before, I was trying to figure out how to finish it. And you guys kept putting all this extra information that I realized wasn't allowing me to say the first story from the very beginning. I was supposed to summarize, remember? You were supposed to guess, well, not guess, figure out what drugs am I trying to stay sober of? What's that main drug that I gotta stay sober of? The most important number. And then what's the other things? What's my mental illness? Exactly. Not what you guys are just guessing by what you see or... All right. I talked right through it, huh? I was saying, wow, the car is messing with me with the clock, and it is. It is now... Yeah, it says 12. But it's 12:50. Yeah. So, that's good. You got me. Look at that beautiful ocean. And I love it. There must have been a storm. It's high tide. Sometimes it comes right out onto here. Yeah, that's pretty exciting. But it's not as crazy as like the Atlantic Ocean, right? On the east side. Was I saying stuff about New York? Hey, New York, you know, I went to school there back in the 80s, and my nephew, who is going to have a child soon, congratulations, who is married to a wonderful woman, someday we will all meet. We missed their wedding, right, because it was COVID times, and I didn't think it was a good thing, just for myself, because mentally, at that time, I didn't want to see anybody. I was holed up in my house. Later, I learned a lot of people did it, so I shouldn't have felt so guilty. Look, that's there where they do their marine biology stuff. Oh, second Seinfeld. Remember when he's a marine biologist?
The sea was angry that day. The old man, like an old man, sending back some soup at a deli. That's right, kids. And that was the day that our protagonist decided to lie about being an architect. That was his usual routine when he went on dates. To be a marine biologist, and he goes and he saves a whale from drowning or something, from suffocating, because Kramer, look at the clues. Did you notice that they were already trying to get Kramer in trouble? Kramer's golf ball. Yeah, Kramer used to go and do illegal things. Illegal things with, that was Kramer's thing. He would do things that we'd say, hey, come on, you should probably pay those 1,000 tickets. I would think by now you owe them a lot of money. And then the guy never talks really about his job, but somehow he's going to pay all of that off, right? He's got some friend who's like a postman, about to go postal, who's like got an in, right? Anyone in government employee number 117 from the Universal Life Church. I will know, children, if you didn't watch the other live streams, that if you don't know that I'm a minister of the Universal Life Church, that means I told you I could marry myself if I wanted to. I'm a minister. I'm not a priest or rabbi or astrology guru. Talk about that cult. We'll talk about the astrology cult later. You know that my daughter's into astronomy and astrology too, so, and my sisters, and we can't talk about it. We won't talk about it, but you need the carpool between 7 a.m. and something. And looky here, it says plug-in electric vehicles okay with EV permit. Do you understand that the lithium, you're gonna get into places, campers, with your lithium batteries, and they're gonna be like, lithium batteries, not in this one. There is a camping spot for you over there. You're gonna see that, and you're gonna be like, discrimination. I already got that with my Tesla, that I can't afford to buy the lithium batteries to make it run. Just look up how many of those situations happen. You're going to say, if you say they're not true, yeah, that's cold. No, it's easy. She redid her hair. She's so beautiful. All right, guys, I'm taking off the mask. I'm putting you here. Please be quiet. All right. Hi.
Hi.
How'd it go?
Good.
Did you learn any new formulas that I might need to know?
Not formulas, actually. It was more on graphs and how to just kind of interpret them with, like...
with the lines and the things?
Yeah, and like how to determine if the second derivative of the function is concave up or concave down, and blah, blah, blah. It's like all this stuff. I'm like, I don't know why this specifically matters, but so it tells you if the function is like positive or negative in certain spots or whatever. It's like,
that sounds really familiar. That particular the functions.
It's functions.
There's some that must be a Sesame Street thing, right? Conjunction, junction, what's your function? They used to have things like that. Yeah, they had things like they would teach us.
Did they teach you calculus?
Well, no, they would teach you word things, you know, like what a pronoun and a pronom is, things like that. And there'd probably be like the square root of something is, you know, 2,000.7, and the square root of 2,000.74 is, you know, stuff like that. Yeah, we were brainy kids. Mm-hmm. You really don't. But you know it's not true. You're like, dad.
No, that was dumb. So dumb. That wasn't sarcastic.
You're so dumb most of the time.
That wasn't sarcastic. I'm just hungry, so my tongue.
Yeah. So you want the usual or?
Sure.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's actually
that,
this time.
That lived.
Oh yeah, I like to try and savor it.
Yeah, me too. I kept
and then I don't want to drink it too fast because then you're just left with ice and the ice tastes really bad. So if you let it melt, then you get more drink and then it kind of blends in and it doesn't taste like water. Bad water.
Like the bad water, yeah.
For some reason, it's funny, ice is the same thing, but when it's ice melted into water, it doesn't taste as good usually, unless it was in water initially.
Oh, the ice. Well, if it's clean, it's just like when it's lying there, like in sometimes in fast food, like when it's been there for a while or something, and it's just kind of icky.
Oh,
and
no.
Then sometimes they don't clean the machine as well. Or they're like, well, we'll clean it tonight. And so then you don't taste it at first because it's all cold. But once it melts, you're like, ugh, what?
Yeah, it always tastes
I think
a little...
I taste a little dirt. Or is that dirt?
Yeah,
or is that grime? Or is that grease? Sometimes I've tasted grease, so you're like, oh, maybe they had, like, they had picked the fries, and then they had taken the cap. I was seeing them do stuff like that there's a place where we used to be able to just make our own coffee at the gas stations, and when COVID happened, they put up this big, like, thing, and they're like, we'll make it for you. This is going to be more safe. And so now it was these... attendants that were like, they'd be cleaning the thing with a cleaning product with these gloves, and then they'd be making you your coffee. And so, look, they would take the top like that, and then you taste like bleach or whatever they use. Do you know what I mean?
Because
you would see them do it, and I'd be like, whoa, maybe you should take off your glove, like after you've cleaned that thing with the cleaning product, and then take. Cap and put it, and they were just like, hey dude, the government has told us how to do this, we know what we're doing. And I'm like, but it tastes terrible. I liked it better when we could make our own coffee. At least we knew it's gonna be my grime. I don't care about putting my germs from my hands onto there. But
maybe
not only that, you're using this product that the science says there's products in here that causes cancer. Now, supposedly we're supposed to be staying away from cancer. But this sign, Marlboro Company has asked us to tell you that there's like 10,000.7 something people dying of cancer every year, and that's like just for us
that's
to
scary.
That's the way to be like, just don't do it.
Yeah,
but they're supposed to be like, don't sell it to us. That's
if they
really the point.
Stop it, then stop
and they
selling.
Shouldn't have that sign because it messes with our minds psychologically. And I feel that people who don't, you know, don't think sometimes about that C word, that they end up not having it. Like, as a classical musician, I'm going to tell you, as a kid, I've seen old ladies at these shows during the breaks. They're like almost 100 years old, and they're smoking a cigarette.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, well, they got away with it, so maybe they are smoking the right cigarette, or they're doing it the right way. They're not doing a lot of it, you know, instead of it them making it the other way around, like it's gonna be the person who was already had an immune deficiency, you know, already had the C word in there. Others were getting it without smoking.
That's the scary thing, is that cancer is just up to chance, usually, for the most part. Even if you do things that should, like, make it happen faster, I guess sometimes it doesn't happen. And then it happens to some really healthy person, and it's really scary. Because it's all down to your cells just duplicating wrong.
It's, what did someone say, right? It's the cards you're dealt.
Yeah,
you can't do anything. That's the house we used to live in. Oh, let's just look for a second. Oh man, it was so cool to live here.
This is a pretty neighborhood.
Yeah. So this house, and and we could go through the back, and all of that is a Mason. It's like a church group of some sort, and so they're never gonna build.
That's where there's a thing for like rabbits, and I had rabbits and stuff. Aww. Until one day I got there and there was just this huge hole, and it's like, oh, coyotes. Yeah.
Oh.
But if you walk straight through there, you can go to that park. It and you end up like going through just the woods. There's like a car that's like gone, like somebody drove a car there once back in the mm-hmm. times, I guess you could, and it's just gone. They probably took like everything that was good of it, and then they just left it there. So there's like a scavenged old car and stuff like that. And then we would get to this spot where they were starting to make the park, which now it has like a little amphitheater out of rocks and
oh,
stuff.
Wow, I love that.
You know, it's a dog park. They got a baseball thing.
Yeah,
it's like super famous. But back then they were like building it without saying anything.
So it just showed up.
And
yeah.
So we were like, whoa, somebody's just like piling these rocks. We were like, there must be some people who are planning to like, you know. I was like, this is the way to be homeless. And then later it's like, oh yeah, now you have to rent the place, like that amphitheater where we were just playing as kids. Mm-hmm. You'd have to call them and be like, can we rent this for this wedding? Like now it's, I did a bunch of weddings there. It's a really beautiful day. Look how big the islands are.
Oh yeah, this is the islands. My brain keeps forgetting directions. My brain keeps forgetting directions.
Yeah. Yeah, sometimes me too. I was just like, oh, it's the mountains, right?
And then you just see the ocean, you're like, wait.
And then
that's pretty.
The last time my friend came to visit, he's like, oh, those are wonderful mountains. What are they called? And suddenly I go, wait a minute. I don't even know the name of the mountains that are behind the house. I think it's Figueroa, right? And then the same thing here. He was like, well, what are the name of the the islands? And I'm like, Santa Cruz? No, wait. Catalina, right?
Islands,
it's
yes.
Catalina.
I was trying to remember because of See Me. I was like, come on, I know this one at least.
You went, didn't you guys?
Yeah.
Right? You did like an overnight?
Was it overnight? I thought we might have had like a few more days. It might have been, like or a, was it just, I don't know.
Oh, a couple, you did a couple?
I think it was
it would make
days.
Sense.
Yeah.
Because it's already like,
you have to go across
get there,
the ocean.
You have to get over the boat sickness.
No, yeah, that sucked, dude. Because, you know, me and my, and so I was sitting there feeling very nauseous, and then I think I asked one of the teachers for like ginger ale and like stuff to try and like help me calm down and stuff, and then she was like, oh well, you know, if you do feel sick, then like you can lean over the edge and stuff. I'm like, I don't want to think about it, stop. I know you're trying to help me, that's scaring me, stop.
Let me help you freak a little more.
Yeah, it's like, don't imply that I will throw up, just tell me I won't and I'll be fine. Like, because everybody was getting sick and like throwing up, and I was just sitting there like, please no. On the way back it was fine though, because I think it was less rocky, and it also started raining. That's fun.
Oh, you reminded me, I was on a big ship, like one of those like cruise, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And I was in the orchestra, and we were the youngest people on this cruise ship. It was like an old timers cruise ship, and back then, yeah, we were like 18 and stuff, and it was just a bad trip. It was a thing where like the bathroom stopped, everything was stinking.
Oh no.
And then the water was so rough, even that thing, like those things are so huge, like there's a parking lot down below.
Yeah.
It's like walking through a mall. They have like shopping malls, like indoor shopping malls. So you have this feeling like you're in some city that's just floating around. And when there's bad weather, wow. It was like the pool lost all
straight
its water.
Up, like,
yeah, and we got to see it like a cartoon, like lift up. Because we were dancing. We took over the discotheque because all the old timers were either in the hallways like barfing in these bags or just staying in their rooms.
Yeah.
But it was that thing where we're the only ones who survived. So we go to the discotheque, there's nobody there, and we're dancing around, and it's just super bad weather. And we look outside, and the whole pool lifted and kept its form like it was jello. Like it was a thing of jello. And then it just crashed down, and we were like, wow. But we had been jumping up in the air at this time.
Uh-huh.
You see the deal? It was such a funny time.
And then we were drunk, so we had no sense of time. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, most of the people said, that probably didn't happen. In the end, we go, nah, we all saw that, but let's not tell anyone. And when they say that the pool's empty and they want to know how it happened, we'll just say we didn't see anything.
We drank it.
Yeah, we drank it. That's funny. That was cool. Someone just put up a notification. It said, you are not coming to my house. Someone's filming themselves right now, not letting the police in. And we got notified. Isn't that amazing? They're going to be like, I have the right, you... It's not like me, where I'm just like, well, yeah, go right ahead. Can we... You came in last time, come in again. They're just like, no way. Stand back. There's going to be this whole, like, trauma. Stand back. There's going to be a showdown. I have the right inside of my private home. The French way is better because they're... You're here, we're innocent until proven guilty, mm-hmm. so they'll just take you to jail no matter what and say, don't worry, you'll prove yourself right in court. We're over there, and here they don't want to hear the story. Like, they don't want to understand the story that could make it so, all right, we're not going to take you to jail. Mm-hmm. They're just like, we're sorry, this is the way it goes. You're innocent, and we're taking you to jail. And then you will prove your innocence, and everything will be okay. In France, they come to the situation and you're guilty. It's guilty before proven innocent. But what's great about that is they have the choice of not taking you to jail or going to court, because they allow you to tell the whole story. And if you're good enough to say, yeah, I'm not guilty, you see, they're like, okay, you're the criminal, you're guilty, prove us wrong. And then they usually go, oh yeah, that makes sense, we're not taking you to jail. No. They didn't beat you up, they didn't spray you with mace, they didn't yell at you to get on the ground, all of that stuff. So I was always telling that to people when they're like, oh, it's so much better in America than in France, because there you're guilty first and we're innocent. Yeah, and I'm telling you, look, the cops never let me tell the whole story. They say, we don't have time for it. Yeah, yeah. We know you're innocent, but we have to go through. Yeah, we have to. Well, it's just the thing. They just go, well, we're just going to stick you in the jail cell. Once you're in the jail cell, the jail people just decide, yeah, you're guilty. They go, because everyone goes to jail and says, I didn't do it.
Yeah.
Each time I went, I wasn't the one saying I didn't do it. I just kept quiet. But everyone else was going, yeah, they say I stole some old lady's purse. It's like usually a thing that they did do. But they're talking like to the cops, and you have to tell them, hey, save it for the judge. Like, I don't need this. And the cops don't believe you either. So why do it? But I hear that's what they do. You go to jail, and they spend the whole time saying that they didn't do it. So then the cops just say, yeah, even if you didn't do it, like, there's always those stories where there's the guy quietly, and they go, oh, he's been in jail for 13 years and we finally got him out. Turned out he didn't do it.
Yeah.
Do you know that story about the person said, like, it was his red sweater, that's all they got him on? They said, yes, the murderer was this red sweater. Yeah. And then it turned out the person was like colorblind or something. Yeah. It's a thing like that, but it took him 13 years to be like, well, wait a minute, a machine wouldn't get that. They'd just be like, well, yeah, red. He had red, the other guy had red. They're both black. That was the thing. African-American. See, if I said they were both black, they'd say, well, we have to let them go. Because you just said something super anti-PC. That's how they let O.J. Simpson go, you know. Because there was a cop who said, yeah, we know, he's the killer, O.J. Simpson. But they went, hey, listen to this tape. You were talking to this writer, and he was trying to... This writer was asking him questions about what it's like to be on the police department. And so he was telling them effing stories about how effing, man, they gotta be tough. They got these N-word people, oh. Right? They're all N's. And that's all. You got problems with the N's of the world. Well, O.J. Simpson happens to be an N. And he's also a killer, but that's not PC. And that's why we're so careful now. It's things like that. It's like, whoa, just because you called him a black man, he's getting set free? Yeah, shh. Policeman, you don't have to be rough like that. But he was just saying it to this girl, like to impress her, to be like, we're badasses. And I think they have to, I guess, to criminals, like, because the criminals must have really terrible profanity and stuff.
Oh, yeah, they have to be.
They're saying it all the time.
Yeah.
So I don't see a cop being
I
like,
listen to a
well, that's very nice, my young bourgeoisie friend. I have seen that the training at the college, your English teacher, you know, was Timothy Leary.
Yeah, I listened to Mr. Ballin thing yesterday.
Oh,
that was God. Let me take my music out so I can actually think. But it was a story about it was a woman that got, you know, very brutally, like, strangled to death and raped, you know, the usual true crime thing. By
no, he wasn't. Okay. So it was like this whole story where they first, like Miss Ball mentioned like a peeping Tom and how, like, you know, this woman felt very unsafe in her house and this whole thing. And then they noticed that there was like how do I retell this? He told it so well.
He's so good. I know. I'm so jealous of him. And he's got nothing. You know how everyone else, they have to do like these jump cuts and stuff, and they do all this exciting stuff, and they're showing you all these crazy pictures, and he'll show you like one thing, and then it's just
photo.
And it's just like you're at a campsite or something,
yeah,
where it's
like,
so perfect.
Like, it's
yeah.
Good. But yeah, basically it was like a whole bunch of like, they thought it might have been the peeping Tom, but that it turned out to be this guy that lived in an apartment complex different from hers, like in the same area. And it was literally just because she went and said hi to his dog and like pet his little dog, and then he was like, I love her now and I was raped and killed her.
Oh,
but,
that,
like, it was that.
Oh, that he had to eat? Wait, that he had to eat her? Is
no.
This the Japanese guy who,
no,
in France? There's a, yeah.
I heard that guy, but God, what's wrong with my throat? I heard that guy, but it's not, no, it's. And raped her. But
just for no reason at all. There wasn't,
because
like,
I think the reason was that she was nice to his dog, and then he was like, oh. Oh, yeah. He was, Mr. Ballin was mentioning the detective of that crime and how he was super nice and really good at his job, but, like, you know, he was good at his job. So when he found, like, the suspect, he immediately was just super, like, we know what he did. You know, that's up. It was, like, super intense.
Right. Maybe repertoire?
That's,
oh, appel actif. That's the call.
I'm just trying to get to the normal setting. Not sure how to sleep.
I think I have to take off my in the phone. I might have to take off oh, here we go. Attends. So it's these buttons. You see, I have a mic off button too. Incapable. You are not. You, with
not
my phone, it's trying to come. Yeah, they're like, the French dude doesn't want to talk
no,
to
I'm
you,
not,
dude.
I'm not getting
I try going to the left. It's going to go to other, it'll say, like, you can hook up your phone. Oh, that's got to be there.
I might
computers.
Just have to end the call. I just want to get
end it. Yeah, get to the spot where, or try please. Maybe it'll say,
I was there.
Oh, sorry, never
one.
Mind.
No, you're good.
we're learning.
Getting, oh, yes.
There's got to be a place where, you know where it says Johan and me and you? Yeah, go ahead. Attends.
Watch, the sheriff just went behind that white van. Huge. There's another one showing up. Now, Johnny Five-O, you know what happened to you here. You were here. They're saying that you have on one of your videos that you said you were, what did you say you were doing? You were dining and dashing. Thank you. You were dining and dashing at the IHOP. Now, the IHOP doesn't isn't there anymore. And I know you were saying to yourselves that as First Amendment auditors, because you got taken down by a library cop, that you were what? Something was wrong, right? That you deserved to take it out on my friends who were working at the IHOP. You know, it's illegal what you did. Dining and dashing. Johnny 5-0. Dude, da 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 da. If you're really saying that you're part of the Hawaii 5 Police Department, while you're Johnny 5-0 down in Kill City, Point Doom, why don't you pick 6 craft beers and beverages and do one of those right now, my first auditor friend. First Amendment auditor, and you didn't show up at La Poubelle. Now the Scientology channels are talking about the trash can. Now, Johnny 5-0, I've decided not to play with the Cash App anymore. As you know, the DAs are on the take, and supposedly all the sheriffs are too. And the correctional facility. Officers, COs, at least that's what the prison wardens are saying. Now the COs, damn, who take care of our animals, right? We do have pets behind bars. And we got guinea pigs. Now, you know my daughter has guinea pigs. And you know I'm going to need cash to play that game that we're doing, which is... dude, that's an unmarked. That's an unmarked emergency 911. What's in that truck? You high five, policeman, don't you? If it's not true, please let me know. But we have a friend named Just Jeremiah's Journey. He is a cult leader in the YouTube off-gridder society in Slab City, California. Did you ever do a First Amendment audit, Mr. Johnny 5-0, whom came to my town? You got busted, dude. You were right up the street from me. Then you went to that hotel. You didn't even come by to see me. I was there in that low-income housing. I'm right up the street from the jail. You knew I was one of your people. Hold on, I'm going to show you when there used to be... Oh, we can do it now again. We can make our own coffees again. Back in the COVID times. Yeah, we couldn't even film any of this. They were saying, do not film us doing this. And I was telling the story to my daughter. They were washing everything with these gloves. And then they were serving us this coffee that we knew how to serve ourselves. And then they would put their hands that had all this stuff, right? This product that supposedly gives us the C word to protect us from this other C word that YouTube wasn't allowing us to say any of the C words. Has that changed now that things are clean? That's always in the same thing. You want to tell me who put those in there? This thing's. All right, so that is covered with this thing that they were cleaning things, and then they were making us coffee, and then it would taste like the cleaning product, and I would point it out to them, and they just say, the government has told us what to do. So remember that. You never explained it. They never explained it. Do we need hats? I think we need eyewear to protect us from people spitting in our eyes. If people were just polite, we wouldn't even need to have them washing their hands. Now they're going to be washing their hands of everything they did during the 2020 and 2022. Those years that they took my life, that's a lot of hours, dude. And you get to do a dine and dash D&D in my neighborhood, effing it off, saying F you. That's not cool. Yeah, make up your mind. You're against us or you're with us? Hi.
How are you?
Good. How you doing?
Good.
Do you think any of these are winning? Do you feel one of these in the $3?
For a $3 one?
Yeah.
The one that I know has been paying off is that one.
Really? Let's go. Yes. 17?
If, okay.
Yes.
And cash only, okay?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Okay. And I promise if it wins, the 30,000 times 15 times that, I can give you one of those 30,000, all right? I would be the least I could do. Oh, it's glow in the dark.
Thank you. It seems like it.
Could I get a pack of Marlboro 27s, please?
Marlboro 27s?
Short? Shorts, please.
Okay.
Oh, awesome.
2277.
Did I tell you the DMV gave me all this money back? They said, for some reason, you don't owe it. And I was like, it's just like that Brazil story. And they went, what? Yeah. Everyone's like, I haven't seen the movie.
Thank you. Matches?
Wow, that would be cool. Thank you for thinking of that. I just realized, yeah, I would have been upset. Oh, Chumash Casino, too.
Yeah.
All right, they go together. Freedom.
Yeah, exactly.
Freedom, it says. You too.
You.
Well, I can't. Use my other hand, hold on. How am I gonna do this? Hold on, I'm gonna stick it in my pocket. I'll talk to you in a second. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, you see before, when I was doing that, during the pandemic, no one had ever heard someone just talking in their phone, but they can't tell that I don't have earphones, right? Because I've grown my hair super long, like I'm that dude. Moist Critical, but now aka Penguin. Yeah, I'm doing his look. That's part of the transition. Ah, if you see him, if I'm wearing the white shirt, it's fine. Hey, look, we might have won. That might be our ticket out of here. Yeah, if you, God, it smells good. Do you guys know about the In-N-Out? This particular In-N-Out is like that, like that jack-in-a-box that Kurt Cobain, right, asked Chris Novoselic. He said, please take me over to this other jack-in-a-box. Chris Novoselic was just making sure Kurt was all right. Kurt, of course, wanted to see his dealer, but fooled Chris by saying, hey, take me to that other jack-in-a-box across town because they have a better, right? They give us more sauce or something. It's the truth. It's the same here. This In-N-Out, it tastes better than any of the other In-N-Outs, but it's because it's the original one, right? With the actual deformed, what is it? It's a deformed palm tree. They use it in their on their T-shirts. This is the Point Market. It's owned by Jeremy. This was the place they never let me come in or use their bathroom or get gas. They would have let me die. And now, now I'm filming policemen going in and out of there. All right, I got these. I hope those will be good. Right, they eat these.
Yeah.
It's chicken feast. Can you do me a favor and put on the dumb again? I think I'm dumb.
Maybe just happy.
Maybe just happy, dum ba dum, dum 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 dum. And then I want to play the cello again. I'm going to play her part. You know, she's a Juilliard graduate, but I went to school music. And they said she couldn't play in tune. A Juilliard graduate, we would have played in tune. But we're the Manhattan School of Music. Manhattan, that's. Manhattan, that's New York. Juilliard is just, yeah, and not only that, Manhattan School of Music just deals with music. Juilliard also has, like, Christopher Lloyd graduated from there. Andy Kaufman, I think, graduated. But they didn't play the cello, right? They were, like, actors. They took theater. They're theater kids. Oh, remember, these washing our cars ourselves. Down,
an auto-tuned cello. Yeah.
I couldn't tell.
Albini said, she said they had to. She wouldn't play in tune. Because she kept saying, she was a Juilliard graduate. She's like, it is so out of tune. Oh my God. You can't fake that stuff. She said she tuned to a machine. They go, well, it's got to be tuned to A440. He just tunes by ear, and they said he was always just like going down to like D. He does a drop D. Well, that's what all the pros say, but he's just playing out of tune. His guitar is way out of tune, so he's playing a flat E, which becomes a D. You see? But a machine's not gonna go, oh, he's not tuning with a machine. He wasn't tuning with a machine, so if she had just tuned like we usually do, we use our ears. You just tune to him, his voice,
yeah,
and his guitar, whatever the string is. And she's like, no, I was taught classically that we got to tune to this 440. So everyone's like, of course, we've heard. And they just didn't figure it out. They're just like, why isn't she playing in tune? And it's like, well, he's playing a D and she's playing a C. Like, and she keeps going.
It's so funny because it sounds perfectly fine. If I liked it being, or I like it being out of tune. It has like a certain vibe to it. That's,
well, he fixed
cool.
it. Yeah, no, he fixed it. Albini. Yeah, see, I read the book about how they recorded it. And that's how I found out.
Old 21 Pilots music.
That's how I found out that it was a Juilliard student. He was like, we shouldn't have gotten her. But he says afterwards, oh, we should have just let her tune by ear. But she was going by her school saying, nope, we got to tune with this machine. And everyone I see right now online, they still do that. They're like, yay, I got this tuner. And they tune to it instead of training their ear. Like yours was trained to be like, wait a minute, that record player is going too fast.
Yeah.
That's the all you do. And all I had to, I was learning it because I was tuning my cello up to play along with.
Mm-hmm.
In tune with it, I had to tune my cello, but not to 440. I had to tune it to 447 or however fast it was. But yeah, it probably would have sounded better if she had been playing out of tune with, because he's playing out of tune. It doesn't sound good when somebody's playing in tune next to somebody who the song, and it's their song. They're saying, no, please play out of tune with me. And the other person's going, no,
yeah,
your song will sound much better if it's in tune. Now they just go, oh, it was drop D. And then after he dies, whatever band, System of the Down, tuned it down to C.
Yeah,
and everyone goes, oh, let's call it lower C. And I was going, no, that's what the cello is. I wish all my bands had done that instead of forcing me to tune up to them. Now they have strings that you can tune down and it doesn't sound weird. Okay. Social services, I gotta go in there next. We'll go there tomorrow after I get a bank account. I'm gonna have a bank account again. And they remembered me, they were just saving it. And the French guy, that was so perfect that there's a French guy there, Jean.
Yeah, that was so
the
cool.
Jean Morisseau we were talking about. That's Jim, you see? So in France, they would have called Jim Morrison Jean Morisseau. And there he was, going, yeah, I know the Doors. Hey, can you see if there's anything in our mailbox?
Yes.
If it's ticking or anything, right? if it comes from YouTube and it's making noise or... It's covered in a white substance. Yeah. Or if there's a nail or something. This is it. I paid taxes and I paid in cash, so I couldn't even use, you know, a loan or something.
Nothing.
Well, it's probably better than any bill.
Yeah.
Or the thing saying, hey, I think we made a mistake by $300. Yeah. Do you remember in the... playing Monopoly, that was like one of the cards. It would always be like, bank makes a mistake in your honor.
Oh,
and it was like $250.
I forgot about that.
Yeah, they would give you money and it would be in the community chest, or what was the other one? Chance. So yeah, you could pick the chance. It'd be like, are you gonna go to jail for cashing that check that they gave you? That you said you think it's their error.
Made, a Monopoly cheaters version, and it's apparently really bad. Like, it's a bad game.
Oh, no, I don't know that one.
Yeah, so...
I know we got a Las Vegas one when we went. Do you remember going to Las Vegas with us as a kid?
I don't really remember. burnt match, so sad.
Well, yeah, we didn't get to do anything. We just stayed inside of a room. It looked like another hotel room. But we got that, like, at the, it, they had this special, like, Las Vegas.
That's cool.
And already there, you were pointing out, like, well, wait a minute. Why is that place that? Like, how did they choose to change it? So I wonder what the cheater one was.
The cheater one, it's basically, the entire game is based around the fact that people like to cheat in Monopoly, and so they take all those cheats and turn it into a board game. And they have, like, one of the cheats is that you actually have handcuffs when you're in jail, even though there multiple people should be allowed to be in jail, but you only get one. And, like, one of the cheats is to be able to get out of that, or, like, people, like, bail you out and, like, whatever. And there's, like, other things.
They get you the key or something.
Something like that? I can't remember.
That sounds kind of fun.
But it's apparently really, like, they try to speed up the entire thing. So, like, you
already buy everything. It's not the thing that you have to go around, land on the thing, decide if you want it.
Yeah, they give you stuff where...
It's already ahead of time. They're like, here's your houses, here's your motels.
Yeah, it takes, like, a long time. Or not a long time. The other way. Yeah. Because there's, like, different cards that make you speed up to go around and whatever. And, like, all this other stuff. And I'm trying to remember
and
the other
it's probably
cheats,
this thing,
but
like,
it's apparently not fun.
We put all the money that would be for random things in the center. And then when you hit free parking, you got this money.
Oh, yeah, I remember
and
that.
And so I used to pile up and pile up. And the only way you could cheat was if you were manipulating the dice. Mm-hmm. So I'm thinking if it's a cheater's game, it's going to be like the dice. It's going to say, well, if you hit a double 12, you know, a double 6, that makes 12, you'll hit it. Either way,
mm-hmm.
But they make the dice that it only goes up to 11, something like that. Like the dice are messed up so that you'll never get that parking spot. That would make sense for a cheater's game.
That's not how
like
they
that.
Do it, though.
No,
it's like I can't remember all of the cheats, but they're like they kind of make everything pointless, and also it's not as fun because I know Monopoly always devolves on people. Fist fighting.
Getting
clearly.
Upset. But, you owe me money. It was because of the IOUs.
Yeah.
And the person going, I didn't say IOU. That's not my handwriting. It's like, come on, can you just pay up? And the person doesn't want to pay up their loan.
Yeah, but it's like they don't... It doesn't have that. And it just kind of... Everybody... Because people can, like, steal stuff from you or, like, mess up the board or whatever. So you have to be just constantly, like...
Watching.
And
there's
it's not
no walking
fun
out of the
you,
room.
You can't,
yeah.
And that's the person that was making a video on it was talking about how it's like, if you leave the room and come back, you're over. Your entire game is done. Like, don't even try.
So
and
if you need the bathroom and
fun.
Stuff. Yeah. The only people who survive are the ones peeing inside of bottles and things.
Yeah,
it's going to get sick.
And you got to just, like, unless you trust your friends a lot.
Well, I would think you'd put a security camera. That way you could go in and you'd be watching on your phone, being like, dude, you're touching...
Who's taking...
You know what I
Monopoly,
mean?
Though.
You're taking my stuff. You can't do that. All right, today we got a... I want to play one of those games. How did the Mario Day end last night?
Oh, we basically... We were calling the entire day. None of us were expecting to stay that long. That was funny. But Robin was able to play for the entirety of Mario DS and then started 64 DS. But he started getting hit with just the, like, this took too long.
Like, yeah, it sounded like you were really up at one point, and then I heard it slowing down, and I was going, that kid's amazing. Like, he sounds like a dungeon master from the old days. Like, he's inventing all this stuff, and I'm like... It's gonna fall at one point, you know what I mean?
You mean like our little skits?
Yeah, I was like, he's gonna start getting tired and you guys are gonna start going, wait a minute. Are you sure that we're supposed to be using the 24-sided dice for this particular thing that we're doing? And he's like sleeping. You don't do what?
D&D?
Well, it would be really good. It's the same deal. You have to be in the same room. It's not as fun when it's...
Yeah. On call might be okay, now that it's just because I'm getting so tired of it. But
on,
the person is definitely better.
On call?
Yeah, on a call.
Oh, you mean when you can hear him on the phone?
Yeah. On the phone.
On the car.
I'm
going
to go in.
Yeah, go in. I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to carry all this.
Is that battery lithium? Hey, remember that Charlie Sheen? Look, I use it here somewhere. Where is that? I got the Charlie Sheen. An old product. Yeah, we used to put it in these containers. It's not going to let me show it to you, but... Yeah, it used to be like in real medicine deals, you'd be getting your prescription from the Charlie Sheen. We're going to be setting up a donation fund for Sarah. And depending on what the people do, maybe we'll still go. It's only 6 hours away, it turned out, Yuma. I'm not, it's actually shorter than going to Slap City, at least from here. I guess through going through LA traffic. But 6 hours, we could get to San Francisco in 6 hours, and we could probably get down to Mexico in 6 hours. So that's a doable one. I could do 3 hours, take a break, do the other 3 hours, and I'd be there. And I think that area, it looks like it's not like Slap City where they wouldn't be able to fix the car. And I'd die out in the heat. And my daughter would be here wondering why I'm not coming back. It looks like it's a normal town. Hey, you guys now greet at the door. Look, they remember how they were fighting? Now they're not. Oh, it's upside down. I don't know why. Yeah, explain it to me, people. Mitchell has still written basic info, advanced settings. We did it, right? That's the first thing we say in the show. So I guess that doesn't work. But now it's covered, so I'm having trouble filming anything. So if Mitchell hadn't put anything on there, it would be clean right now. So for 4 hours, I've been trying to film with this camera that people are saying, well, go in, do this. And I'm telling you, it's not working. So if the person hadn't written anything, or if the chat button really did work when I turned it off, which it's off, I would be able to see and not have this blocking my view. Now, you guys don't see it, so it's as though it's not happening. And my daughter says there is a way of fixing it, so we're going to do that. But I think we can only fix it on the computer, so I wouldn't be able to use the phone. And you know the places I'm going to. I don't think I should bring a computer. But in Yuma, I think I would have some place that would be safe, right? And it wouldn't be that one place in Nyland next to the... What is that? It's not an IHOP, but a Best Buy, they said. Or something, a Costco. Something connected to us next to the Mexican border. Arizona, Yuma, it's not going to be that Mexican border. There won't be that tunnel underground. It won't be that thing you're telling me. You hear that? We're fixing the shower. I'll be able to take a shower. I'm going to do the same thing as Sarah. It seemed to make her look very happy. So maybe Carlos got it right when he was telling us all. Why don't you guys attempt to take a shower? I forgot what other things he said. It doesn't work, right? I told him, hey, you know, it's a little more complicated than that. And he wrote, ha, ha, ha. You're funny. I don't know what you're going to say next. And I was being serious. We didn't go to the Oscar party yesterday. We didn't even look at the Oscars. Why? Because of the time of Mr. Smith trying to hit a comedian off the stage. And then we go to Netflix. We see this comedian. He's going to tell us the story. What happened? What happened, Mr. Hart? And he waited to the very end to tell the story, because everyone would have left had he done it in the beginning. They had only come to the show. They'd only come to the show for that story. And he knew from YouTube, he knew, you gotta wait to the end, right? You gotta drag people to the end. You gotta make them in the middle think, yeah, at the end I'll tell you what happened. I'll tell you about that brick that was heard. Sarah threw a brick at someone who's now sober. But before, this person screamed all the way to the hospital, then the next day made a video in the Slab City Canal, yeah, hot tub, hot springs, with that music, sad music, owned by YouTube, not us. They paid for it. And they used that music so that when they told the story, we felt very, very sad for them. In real life, we're not gonna be able to do that, right? Sarah did hers, her version of it, totally silent, very calm. This other person was telling one story. Now they're sober. They say that the story never existed. The brick that was heard all around YouTube, offline community. We're sorry, I think there's a story you guys don't want to talk about. No, it's okay. She's sober. She's got a new name. She's got a new channel. We're happy for her. And Sarah never really had a problem with all of that. Because of that brick, because of having to go to jail for 12 days, with broken arms, she's calling from the prison phone saying things like, yeah, I'm doing handstands and things to stay well. Meanwhile, Just Jeremiah's journey is setting up these videos in Hawaii, in some campsite. He's in a blue tent. He's inside of the tent. He turns on his phone like we have to. It's pointing toward him. He's looking at it, sadly, like, dude, this is gonna hurt. And then all these people on the outside started to bash his face. And he was yelling. No, he wasn't. He was just saying, this is my YouTube channel. And I'm filming you guys. And they said, we don't need you here, right? And he took him to court and he filmed all this. Now he's gone. What happened? Whose fault was it? Only certain people could have told you. But Sarah's still here. And I'm still here. And we started this whole thing on her birthday, 7 years ago. You weren't here, N.E.A.L. And you weren't here, my trolls. So you all kind of lost. But I am thinking, right? Maybe. Maybe.